and gets hit right about at the same spot where he fielded the punt at the 27. 55-yard punt. Well, the Mountain West Conference not only playing here in the New Mexico Bowl as BYU takes on UTEP, but here are the other games that will involve Mountain West Conference teams. The Las Vegas Bowl will feature Boise State taking on Utah. The Poinsettia Bowl, San Diego County Credit Union Poinsettia Bowl with Navy against San Diego State. Independence Bowl with Air Force and Georgia Tech. And, of course, we'll see TCU on New Year's Day.
That'll be an interesting game with Wisconsin. The running game for Wisconsin against that defense from TCU and Gary Patterson's group. But they're going to face an offensive line and a power running game that they have not seen to date this season. And that's one of the more interesting games out at the Rose Bowl that I'm looking forward to watching.
Well, we had Wisconsin earlier this year as one of our games, and I'm not sure that any players in college football, for the most part, see an offensive line like that till they start playing on Sundays.
That's an NFL offensive line, there's no doubt. And there's a couple NFL backs probably playing behind them. So Bronco gets the... Did he fake him out?
He was trying to dodge them, and he actually gave a little fist bump. I think he stayed dry. Careful, Bronco. Yeah. If you start to taunt your players like that, there's more than one bucket over there. They might find you after all is said and done.
He may want to go get a jacket, find a jacket somewhere.
Oh!
Oh, they got him.
Let's see. He dodges the bucket and then gives him the fist pump. Yes. That's right. That's how good I am. And then all of a sudden they found a couple of the squeegee bottles. Clark to take one more knee. Officially ends the 2010 New Mexico Bowl. Bronco Mendenhall now soaking wet, and he gets the ride that every football coach lives for, especially from his seniors, as they end with an above 500 season and a 52-24 win here in Albuquerque.
That's got to feel great for Bronco Mendenhall, and the start of the season they had to finish it this way is a great job.
Coming up next, it's the Utrove Humanitarian Bowl for live coverage of our trophy presentation. Log on to ESPN3.com. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Brian Greasy and Jen Brown, I'm Bob Wischusen. So long from Albuquerque, now to Boise and the Utrove Humanitarian Bowl.
The blue turf, welcome to the Utrove Humanitarian Bowl in Boise, Idaho, part of ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week. The Battle of the Dogs, the Huskies of Northern Illinois taking on the Bulldogs from Fresno State, Broncos Stadium in Boise, Idaho. I'm Carter Blackburn with Oregon's winningest head football coach, Mike Bellotti, and former All-Pac-10 quarterback at the University of Washington, Brock Huard. Tom Matukiewicz is the interim head coach for Northern Illinois. Head coach Jerry Kill accepting the job offer at the University of Minnesota. It has been an eventful 2 weeks for Northern Illinois. The question is, how do the Huskies deal with a disappointing loss in a MAC championship game and a shakeup in the coaching staff?
You know, I think despite that adversity, they're genuinely happy to be here. Coach Matukiewicz is like a kid in a candy store. He wants this so bad. He's head coach for a day, and he's going to make the most of it.
Mike, we have met with many coaches this season. I don't know if I've ever seen more joy than we saw yesterday with Coach Matukiewicz.
The true excitement. He's ready to roll the dice and let her go.
Well, Fresno State and Pat Hill have made their reputation beating the big boys in college football in bowl games, 4-1 against teams from the BCS automatic qualifying conferences, 0-5 against teams from the non-automatic qualifying conferences, including the last two seasons. Fresno State will kick it off to get the 2010 Utrove Humanitarian Bowl started. Tommy Davis will take a knee in the end zone. Northern Illinois takes the football from the 20. Let's take a look at the impact players when the Huskies have the football.
Well, it starts and ends with Chad Spann, the MAC Offensive Player of the Year. He broke the school's single-season touchdown record with 20 because of his balance and knowing his strengths.
On the other side of the ball, the team MVP on defense, the league MVP on defense, Chris Carter, great pass rusher, great overall player. Next to him, Logan Harrell, also a force inside, has 10.5 sacks, but also can stop the run.
First and 10 for Northern Illinois out of the MAC, losing the MAC championship game on December 3rd, so just over 2 weeks ago, to Miami in heartbreaking fashion. Come from behind win for Miami. Harnish on the roll, throwing on first down, completing to the 45. It's Nathan Palmer who makes the grab.
They talked about needing to get play action chunks. Both teams are very similar. A run game basis that sets up the great play action throw down the field.
And you can see those very aggressive linebackers from Fresno State attack. They leave space in their zone. And Nathan Palmer delivers.
Robert Reeves is calling the plays today for Northern Illinois. Both coordinators also leaving with Coach Jerry Kill to Minnesota. On first and 10, Harnish is going to keep it himself and pick up about 5 more yards. Plummer finally makes a stop.
Well, Harnish was the player, quarterback all-league guy because of two things. He led in pass efficiency. He's also averaging 6 yards a carry. Great decision making.
In fact, Northern Illinois had a 47-year-old record he broke this season in total offense, just a hair under 3,000 yards with both the arm and the legs.
Give credit to his offensive line, too, and his decision making. Only been sacked 13 times in 13 games this year.
Willie Clark goes in motion on 2nd and 5. Play fake to Span. Harnish to the air again. Complete again. First down, Northern Illinois again. This time it's Willie Clark who's the man in motion to the 37. 10 wins on the season for Northern Illinois. A Husky football team has never won 11 at the big goal in Northern Illinois for this bowl game. We already showed you Fresno State 0-5 against teams from the non-automatic qualifying BCS conferences.
I asked Pat Hill about every which way I could yesterday, trying to interrogate him as to why that's happened, and he did not have a definitive answer other than some of the conditioning levels, something they've mixed up this over the last 2 weeks for Fresno State.
Harnish over the middle, complete again. It's Landon Cox who makes this grab. Brought down by Ben Jacobs, the leading tackler for Fresno State. Look at the differential in turnover margin between these two.
This is the biggest significant difference, a difference of 20-point differential in turnover margin. Again, the reason that Fresno's only won 8 games this year, whereas Northern Illinois is 1-10 going for 11.
And the Huskies have done a brilliant job of taking care of the ball. Just one fumble and 350-some carries, and Chandler Harnish just 5 interceptions all season.
Spain gets it on 2nd and 5, and he is dropped for a loss by Lauren Bell, the strong safety.
I really like Lauren Bell, a 5th-year senior, a guy that's overcome so much, a devastating knee injury in 2007. And every one of those coaches and teammates will tell you he's the hardest hitter on this team.
Well, he's down in the box, too. Both teams are going to put 9 men in the box if they can and stop the run. Make the teams throw. That's their mantra.
And that will be key all day long. He's the extra guy unaccounted for in the blocking scheme, and he must tackle well in space.
3rd and 4. Harnish's pass high and incomplete, intended for Ashford. Deesha Dunn had a shot at the interception.
Don't see that much inaccuracy from Chandler Harnish, a guy that completed 64% of his passes. That was just a miss. He had an open receiver, nice combination. They go 4 receivers to one side. He just can't find him on 3rd down.
All right, guys, here it is, 4th down. Tom Matukowicz, first game as a head coach. He told us he was going to cut it loose.
Roll the dice, and again, they said they wanted and felt they needed some success early.
4th down, Northern Illinois going for it. Pressure coming. Harnish passes incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Shepler. Smith breaks it up.
Great play by Darren Smith to step in front. That's a key down. That's just like a turnover right here, getting the ball in very good field position.
You go for those 4th down situations to try to continue momentum. And that's a pretty easy route recognition. Fresno State does a lot of that. They train their secondary, their safeties and corners to recognize what's ahead of them. Chandler Harnish is going to have to get a feel for that playmaking ability from the Bulldogs.
Bulldog defense gets a stop. Fresno State gets the football at the 30. Senior quarterback Ryan Colburn from under center swings it in the flat. Evans makes the grab on the screen.
Watch that, because that was a lateral right there. That could set up a double pass later on in the game. And again, that's a dangerous throw, because if it's fumbled, it's a live ball back there.
Ryan Kohlberg's been very hot here down the stretch. Had a brilliant game that we got to see 2 weeks ago. This is very much a pro-style passing offense. His rhythm's important. That's why you're going to see, I think, early in this game, trying to find completions for the southpaw.
Four wide receivers on second down for Fresno State. Colburn from the shotgun finds Evans again. Evans makes the first defender miss. First down Fresno State. Let's check in with a fourth member of our broadcast crew, Shelly Smith.
Guys, you'll notice that Robbie Rouse, Fresno State's running back, is playing with a huge club on his hand. He missed the last game of the regular season with a rib injury, but he also broke a bone in his hand. He didn't know about it until the next day. They put the club on. He's gotten pretty good at it. He actually wore a similar cast when he broke his wrist in high school. They are more concerned, however, about his ribs, how he will respond to contact.
There is no doubting that young man's toughness, playing through the broken bone in the hand through a very painful rib injury. It was the cartilage between his ribs that kept him out of their last game of the regular season against Illinois. And here is Rouse. His first touch goes for a loss. Let's take a look at the impact players when the Bulldogs have the football.
Well, it starts with Robbie Rouse. Again, he's the emotional leader of that team. Playing today with a cast on his hand, he is so quick and so explosive. He can make you miss in a phone booth.
And for Illinois State, watch defensive end number 54, 26-year-old ex-Marine, inspirational leader, their most productive defensive player. And on the back end, first team All-MAC corner Chris Smith covers very, very well. Best coverage guy, also tough. He, too, has played through a fractured hand this season.
Fly sweep. Produces a first down as Jalen Saunders, the true freshman from Elk Grove, California, gets the handoff on the sweep.
You get those edge runs, Mike. You've got to have help outside, people blocking on the perimeter.
No question. And I'll tell you what, the other thing is right now, Fresno State's speed advantage on the flanks is showing up. They're getting outside and making yards outside the range of the NIU defense.
Fresno State's first possession inside the 40, out of the eye. It's Rouse, who picks up nothing. Number 13 rusher in the football bowl subdivision, averaging 110 rushing yards a game.
And you're going to notice this today with that club. There is no way for him to carry that ball in the left hand. So even when he runs to the left side, that's a point of emphasis for Northern Illinois as well. They know every one of his carries, that ball will be tucked firmly in his right hand.
He carried 96 times in a three-game span in the middle of the season, and it may have been too much for him.
On second down, out of the eye, this is A.J. Ellis, who is dropped by Chris Smith. You see the giant club, or what would you call it, a Q-tip, Mike?
Q-tip, club, yeah, it's to protect that hand. I'll tell you what, it makes it difficult. But great play by their Chris Smith. As a corner, he's got 63 tackles on the season, which he's involved a lot.
So when you face a guy like that, Mike, and in these situations on third down, what do you do from a coverage standpoint? Because you've got to factor Fresno State can't check the ball down to a guy with one hand, can they?
Well, it'd be interesting to see if they start rotating running backs in obvious pass situations. I think I would.
Well, this is third and 11, and there's Rouse in the backfield.
He's a threat. He can still catch the ball. I know they talked about they weren't sure how many times they wanted to throw it to him.
Huskies bring pressure. Colburn picks it up. But how about the open field tackle by Tommy Davis after the grab by Hamler? But the spot on the forward progress appears to give Fresno State a first down.
Check out our little impact player. We talk about that club. That is effort. And that is why Pat Hill yesterday loves this guy, loves his toughness, loves his energy. He's one of those guys, Mike, and you know this, when they come in the huddle, they just elevate everybody else because you're seeing what he's playing through.
You can see the intensity in his eyes, and it carries over when he plays.
Fresno State's opening possession inside the Northern Illinois 30. Play fake on first down. Colburn pressured from behind. Slips away from Kaufman, but the pass is dropped by Austin Raphael, the fullback.
One of the things Northern Illinois talked about was getting pressure from the backside away from the man protection across on the zone side. They felt they could get there, and certainly that time, the pocket play action, they didn't have enough time for the route to develop down the field.
They showed Jake Kaufman and company a tape of 30 throws. where Colburn was most inaccurate, and every time it was with contact, pressuring him. They want to make sure they make him uncomfortable, especially early.
Second down, it's Rouse hit again near the line of scrimmage. So the Fresno State running game, where they hang their hat, has produced very little in the early going.
Well, that's okay. And Pat Hill told us this yesterday. He said with the style that Northern Illinois plays, as much movement and blitz and slanting, they're going to win at times in the run game, and that's fine. They still have to establish it because it's critical in their play action game.
And good running teams have to be patient. It's not going to always open up. You're always going to gash them. But if you keep working it, sometimes that size of that Fresno State offensive line is going to wear down NIU's defensive line.
Third and nine. Colburn on the slant. It's Hamler again. And he appears to have the first down again to the 17.
One-on-one coverage outside. You have a fifth-year quarterback that realizes his go-to receiver, and that's turned into Jamal Hamler this season. Leading receiver, that's just too soft to coverage on third and nine.
Yeah, you notice the cover corner was way inside, but still allowed to slant. You've got to take one thing away.
Wildcat formation here is Isaiah Burse. Lines up at QB. Direct snap, he hands it off. That's Saunders around the corner, and he's knocked out inside the 10.
And again, right now, we've talked about the speed of Fresno State. They're getting mileage out of the fly sweep because NIU is packing the box. They've got 9 men in the box, but they're vulnerable on the flanks.
I think right now we're seeing some of the perimeter speed advantage Fresno State outside and third down situations on their routes, their perimeter run game. From way up here in the press box, that's pretty evident, and this is going to be imperative for Northern Illinois when they get out on that perimeter. They tackle well this afternoon. When some team is faster than you, you better tackle well in space.
Robbie Rouse gets it. Hoffman may have gotten away with a face mask as he makes the tackle on Rouse.
I'll tell you what, it looks like the Huskies are keying on Rouse. He has not got a chance to get started. And again, he can be a decoy, though, and set up the outside plays.
Don't you love the effort there? Does he get the headgear? No, I think he's just right there on the shoulder pads in the jersey. And the 26-year-old, as I said, served 2 tours in the Middle East. Coach Matukiewicz loves the veteran leadership he has on this team.
Third down again for Fresno State. Colburn on the run. Heaves it for Hamler, who comes back to the football. Touchdown, Fresno State. The third time on third down that Colburn finds Jamal Hamler, this time for a touchdown.
Patrick George is trying to say that he didn't get his feet down in bounds or have possession. It'll be interesting to see. Here we take a look right now.
Only need 1 foot in.
Yeah, he's got it. There. Got it with the foot in bounds. Control of the football with the foot in bounds.
Great teaching point. You have a guy outside in a one-on-one situation that you trust. Put some air on it. Let him go find the ball and make the play.
Previous play is under further review.
Brock, you're absolutely right. When you're in pressure, you know to go with your receiver. Throw it up for him. Let him make that play. You, as a quarterback, you know that exactly.
So as it stands now, an 11-yard. And again, keep in mind that only 1 foot or other body part needs to be in bounds. So it's not like the NFL where you have to have both feet in bounds, just one. Keep that in mind as you watch not only today's game, but the rest of the 33 bowl games we bring you on the ESPN Family of Networks.
Does he have possession? That's one of the other things they're looking at. I think he clearly does. My guess is we're going to see more difficult replay calls later.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
Only the fifth opening drive touchdown of the season for Fresno State. So what a start for the Bulldogs. Pat Hill's team gets a stop on fourth down to get the football. They march down, put it in the end zone.
And that's the start. Then both teams, it's really bowl games about who's most excited to be here, who has the most to prove. And Fresno State, being 0-5 against non-AQ teams, has to take a big step. They took the first step today.
Fresno State converts 3 times on the opening drive to get in the end zone. All to Hamler.
I like to make my own investment decisions.
Excuse me, what is that?
Oh, I'm a Fidelity customer.
Okay, but what does it do?
Well, it gets me the tools and research I need to help me make informed decisions. With Fidelity, I can invest in stocks, bonds, all at a great price.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Fidelity Investments. Turn here. Taco Bell's $2 meal deal. Each with a Taco Bell original, Doritos chips, and a medium soda. Three items, $2. Now that's a deal.
So I buy a beefy five-layer burrito and drink, and you throw in the chips for free?
How about you just give me $2, and it's all free?
Let's do it. Why pay more?
Do you know what's amazing? The Olympus Pen. What makes it so amazing isn't the fact that it's as powerful as a professional digital camera and as simple as a point-and-shoot. Or that it has interchangeable lenses and art filters that make it easy to get creative. The most amazing thing about the Olympus Pen is that this commercial shot with one.
And cut.
Pro quality, point-and-shoot simplicity, HD video, all in one. The Olympus Pen. Look what you can do.
That's so dumb.
Don't be left behind. Get it first with AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network, period. Rethink possible.
As the title sponsor, we'd like to welcome you to the UDrove Humanitarian Bowl from Boise, Idaho. UDrove's unique smartphone-based solution helps truck drivers and mobile professionals every day lower their costs by removing the hassle of managing paperwork while on the road. We're excited about aligning ourselves with this bowl game in order to recognize the humanitarian efforts of the transportation industry, which is the lifeblood of our economy. Thank you for joining us today for what we know will be a fabulous kickoff to the College Bowl season. Enjoy the game.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio. You're watching ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
Fresno State has a 7-0 lead in the 2010 UDrove Humanitarian Bowl. Opening drive touchdown for the Bulldogs. And welcome back to Boise, Carter Blackburn with Mike Bellotti and Brock Heward. Well, Coach Matukowicz said he was going to go for it early. Fourth down, first opportunity. The interim head coach for Northern Illinois, they go for it. Doesn't work out, but I mean, that there is an attitude certainly for Northern Illinois. Nothing to lose.
It is, and I don't know if they had a lot of choice. They have an inconsistent field goal kicker. We talked about that going in. They wanted to get success early, but Fresno State, certainly their defense was up to the task.
That's two things to watch, I think, very closely. In these situations on fourth down, on special teams, are you going to see Riverboat Gamblers? Is he just going to shoot from the hip? I think he is, from what we heard yesterday and talking to him. And then secondly, I think for the players, when adversity hits, if they find themselves in a hole, you're not hearing the same voice, your coordinators are gone, your head coach is gone, do they rally around or do they just kind of say, you know what, enough's enough, we're in a messy situation here, it's dysfunctional, and just tune out?
One other thing, the speed, though, of Fresno State on the flanks is a factor in this game and something that NIU has to come up with an answer for.
Tommy Davis dragged down at the 32. Northern Illinois gets the football when we come back.
Once a year, truck drivers across North America volunteer to drive a cargo of honor, respect, and integrity by delivering wreaths to the cemeteries of American veterans. Truckload Carriers Association is proud to support Wreaths Across America.
It's a 403 horsepower, 6.2 liter V8. Nutcracker. The 2011 GMC Sierra. During the GMC holiday event, get 0% financing and a $1,500 allowance when you purchase a 2011 Sierra. Plus, make no monthly payments until spring. It's our best offer of the year.
I told you you were too close, but nobody ever listens to me. No, 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 no. I mean, who does that? Backs a car into another car? You know what? You make my head numb. I can't even.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
I'll take care of this.
With a new boyfriend. Hot.
With a new girlfriend.
Oh, this is what you like.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. I was perfect the way I was.
Okay.
State Farm agents are there when you need them.
I say, hey.
The Battle of the Bands, 1 o'clock today. And they are continuing to battle inside of Broncos Stadium, usually home of the Boise State Broncos. Their WAC compatriots for now. Fresno State against Northern Illinois out of the back. Play fake from Chandler Harnish on first down. He's gonna roll away from the pressure from Carter and heave it incomplete.
They may have gotten away with a takedown on Logan Harrell. It was one of the best tackles, form tackles I've seen, but I don't think you can do that on offense.
You know, we've talked about this with different quarterbacks this season. Watching inside to battle 77s, Harrell gets a little push from his buddy next to him. We've talked about quarterbacks early on in games, especially a couple weeks off, and as excited as you are to play with everything that's gone on with Northern Illinois. Now, that's a couple times that Harnish has sailed a few passes. To me, a sign of being overexcited.
Ricky Kreider in at tailback now for Northern Illinois. Harnish is going to keep it on second down.
Great idea to get to a manageable third down. Again, you throw an incomplete pass on first down, come back, run, get something to set up a manageable third down situation.
And keep in mind, for Northern Illinois, Robert Reeves, the former running back coach now, has been elevated, not just from running back coach, but to coordinator. And for the first time in his career, calling plays for Coach Tom Matukiewicz, who you see there, who's also the first time ever as a head coach, the one-time linebacker coach here at Northern Illinois.
Huskies have been excellent on third down this season, in part because what Mike just mentioned, third and manageable. Harnish's pass is batted away, incomplete. Here comes a flag.
Probably going to be pass interference. Again, both guys were hand fighting with each other, but they typically go against the defense in that situation.
Defense, number 10, 15-yard penalty, first down.
One-on-one route, you know, bump and run coverage at the line of scrimmage, which is exactly what both teams are going to try to do. But hanging on, you can't hold that guy's shoulder when he's going for the football. And this is like a bye week game for both of these teams. They played 2 weeks ago, but the finals, etc., there were a lot of distractions, so it's not exactly like coming back from a bye week.
And so there are advantages and disadvantages of playing on December 18th. I mean, you said it's 2 weeks ago, these teams were on the field playing in the regular season. So there's some wrinkles for both of these teams and programs, really, having just a week off between the end of the season and the bowl game. On first and 10, Harnish from the shotgun, play fake. Now he's going to pump. He's going to look long. Intended for Moore, who holds it in inside the 15. Martell Moore. The sophomore from San Antonio, Texas, hauls it down at the 12.
Great job of going up and timing the catch, taking the ball at the highest point, which you talk to receivers all the time. You see, you get the position here, going back inside, double move route, and then highest point, go up and attack the football with both hands. Love to see that from
And when you're 6'1 and 5'9, you've got to take advantage of your length, and Clark does.
39-yard pass play. Martell Moore hauls it in. Span gets the handoff on first down, picking his way inside the 10 after the initial contact. He picks up about four before Sean Plummer makes the stop.
Chad Spann, they talk about he's so tough to tackle because he protects his body. You can see he takes it on with his shoulder pads, doesn't allow him to get to his legs, and breaks a couple tackles. Did not gain a lot of yardage, but got positive yardage.
You can't say it enough about running backs. It's all about pad level. Keeping that pad level, your shoulder pads lower than the defenders, and then having the ability, as you saw Spann there, to continue to drive those legs.
Empty backfield, five wide for Northern Illinois on second down. Inside the 10. On his pumps, he's going to keep it himself and walk in for a Northern Illinois touchdown. 7 yard run.
Well, I know Northern Illinois has had new coaches and new schemes and new coordinators, but it's very easy to look at the stats. Fresno State, 7th in America in sacks, and when you face an aggressive group like that, quarterback draw, tremendous call.
Michael Klimovsky on for the extra point. Harnish will hold. Klimovsky, the senior law school student. He has missed 5 PAT kicks this year. This one is no good as well. The 6th miss on a PAT. So a touchdown for the Huskies, but only 6 on the board.
Join Boomer and the gang for Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
It's Red Lobster's ultimate surf and turf event with 3 seafood and steak combinations all under $20, like succulent lobster and wood-grilled sirloin or new Chardonnay shrimp and sirloin. End soon at Red Lobster.
New Garnier Fruit Tease Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. Fights flakes for 48 hours. Guaranteed.
The 11-1 Boise State Broncos are out to cap their second straight top 10 season. But Utah awaits with the nation's best bowl win streak on the line. Capital One Bowl Week continues with Utah-Boise State in the Mako Bowl, Las Vegas. Wednesday at 8 on ESPN. College football lives here.
The contrast of infinite black. The clarity of fast-switching phosphors. The smoothness of 600 hertz. All come together to create what CNET calls the best picture quality of any 2010 TV. The Viera Full HD 3D TV from Panasonic. Get a bonus Avatar Blu-ray 3D disc from Best Buy when you buy a Viera 3D TV.
We've got your car in stock. Let's just check out your credit score and we'll work out your financing.
Sounds good.
Did you know everyone has 3 credit scores? And just one bad score could really hurt you.
Whoa! That's gonna be a problem.
What do you mean?
Your credit score could be affected by inaccuracies or even identity theft. Now tracking your score is easy at freescore.com. Unlike other services that only provide one score, freescore.com lets you see all 3 credit scores for free. Get your scores now at freescore.com.
Free score! Freescore.com!
In the 5th meeting between Northern Illinois and Fresno State, one thing we know today, gentlemen, Victor E. will be the winning mascot.
Victory Husky or Victory Bulldog?
Well, that's the question, Mike. You alertly noticed that both mascots' names, the Husky, that's Victor E. Husky. Fresno State's mascot is Victor E. Bulldog. Now Brock asked the question, who's Victor? But Victor E. Victor E.
Victory. All right. Yeah. Cool.
Takes it from inside the 10. Burst across the 35. Isaiah Burst cuts it back. Blue turf in front of him. Now Burst tries to cut it back. Loses 3 at the end, but it's a tremendous return for the true freshman from Modesto, Isaiah Burst.
And again, the speed factor shows he is so shifty in the open field. He's a guy, he's averaging 15 yards a carry on the ground as a receiver.
You want to know why Pat Hill has got Fresno State to the 11th bowl game in 12 years? Well, because he's recruited speed like that, you're going to see it all over the field. Jalen Saunders, number 6, true freshman. Isaiah Burst, they're going to have him run and throw it. And in the return game, true freshman, lots of speed in the program.
Both these teams excellent in special teams, but advantage Fresno State right now. A 55-yard kickoff return. Colburn swings it in the flat. Evans is wrapped and dropped by Patrick George. Let's go back to the Husky touchdown.
Look at the width of Chris Carter. That tells you pass rush, but more importantly, Coach, look at your middle linebacker, Ben Jacobs.
No question. He bites on the pass fake outside, trying to get 4-on-3, opens up the lane for the quarterback draw. Well-coached play. They saw that. They saw that in films and set that up.
That is officially a pass for minus 3 yards, making it second down and 13 for Fresno State in the all red on the blue turf. Burst from the Wildcat for a loss as we check in with Chris Fowler.
All right, thanks, Carter. Reminder, the Stag Bowl Division III championship game going on ESPNU. The sixth straight year, Wisconsin and Whitewater, the defending champs, they got on Mount Union, 3-point game late third quarter again over on you. We'll keep you posted. Back to you guys.
Tom Matukowicz, the interim head coach for Northern Illinois, says, bah humbug, all these people who say there's too many bowl games. He loved bringing his team to Boise, guys from all over the country. He said, you got big offensive linemen from Florida.
Sledding down a hill
in Boise, Idaho. Love it. They said it's been a real blessing to spend this week in Boise, Idaho. Effusive in his praise of this town. Colburn is going to be pressured by Kaufman, slips away again, but there the tenacious Jake Kaufman ends up getting the sack.
Well, we're going to have effusive praise, I think, a lot today from Jake Kaufman. We've seen it in the run game, and that time just relentless, and that epitomizes his game. As I said earlier, 26-year-old ex-Marine, 2 tours in the Middle East, loves to play and wants to finish this thing outright as a redshirt senior.
Fresno State's got to be frustrated. They get the great kickoff return to answer the scoring drive and then can't take advantage of it.
Northern Illinois, tremendous punt blocks at 3 in a game earlier this year against Ball State. Shapiro gets this one off, hangs it high. Davis lets it bounce out of bounds. Poor punt coming there. Tuesday night, Capital One Bowl week continues. Southern Mississippi against Louisville in the Beef O'Grady's Bowl, St. Petersburg. Capital One Bowl week on ESPN Tuesday, 8 Eastern. Game also available on ESPN Radio, online at ESPN3.com, and on your phone. Well, you won't get many more student athletes with a better story than Jake Kaufman that we just saw him make that sack on that last play, Brock. You mentioned the two tours of duty with the Marines. He was a combat engineer. Rarely does he ever talk about his time during the service.
But you know what? He doesn't give up. He got down on the ground, got up, and made that play, which is what you would hope if you're in a foxhole somewhere with him, he would do that.
Sweep, short gain on first down. So Northern Illinois running back Chad Spann said it was a bit of a surprise to the team when Kaufman brought it up. His service, said before one of his tours in Iraq, their commanding officer was taken away from their unit. They kind of looked at one another and said, you know what, we love one another, we love our unit, we love being Marines. Let's go to it. Let's get the job done. It's a similar thought. Head coach Jerry Kill leaves for Minnesota, a bowl game to play. Jay Kaufman said, we love playing football, we love one another, let's get the job done in Boise.
Nice job of moving the pocket there to buy a lot of time. Deep running routes down the field, and again, needed time, but moved the pocket well. Harnish under control, throwing the ball. Here you can see again the route, sort of a crossing route. They cross and stop, get the trade-off of the DBs. Nobody covers the outside receiver.
When you are playing a team that is adept at pass rush, as Fresno State is, you know this, Mike. Move the pocket, like the body control of Nathan Palmer as well. Draws, screens, consistent and different launch points. That's how you slow down a pass rush.
Touchdowns in the first quarter for both Northern Illinois and Fresno State. A missed PAT, the difference after one in Boise.
Christmas Day, Bulls Knicks on ESPN, then Celtics Magic and Heat Lakers on ABC.
Today's economy depends on the $660 billion trucking industry, and truck drivers depend on U-Drove. Trucks bring life's essentials, From hauling equipment to football games, to bringing snacks and drinks for your tailgate party. To remain competitive, trucking companies are lowering costs and advancing productivity with UDrove. By eliminating paperwork, UDrove is helping to make the trucking industry more efficient. UDrove, we'll do the rest.
Water damage strikes fast. So do we. When you call the cleanup specialist at 1-800-SERV-PRO. Like it never even happened.
Can a trading site help make you a sharper trader? Mine can.
TD Ameritrade can.
They've got trading specialists I can call for help.
And paper trading.
Free practice trading that helps me hone my technique.
Complex options.
And free tutorials, online or in person.
Can a trading site really make a difference?
If it can't, why are you trading there?
Number one in online equity trades, TD Ameritrade.
Trade commission free for 30 days. Plus, get up to $500 when you open an account.
To everyone who received the beautifully designed Buick LaCrosse during our holiday event, enjoy. To everyone who didn't, well, there's still time. During the Buick holiday event, sign and drive this Buick LaCrosse for $387 per month with nothing due at signing. It's our best offer of the year.
It was just gigantic.
It was humongous.
Enormous, huge bill.
That's actually when we switched to Vonage.
The service is great.
I don't see any difference with the call quality.
More, I can just pick up the phone, call
as many family members as I want. Ugh, why did I not do this earlier? I'm Laura Pruden, and this was my last bill
before I switched to Vonage.
Switch your home phone service to Vonage and get unlimited U.S. and international calling for $14.99 a month. Now without an annual contract. Go to Vonage.com or call now.
Hey, he went to Jared.
He definitely went to Jared. That's a peerless diamond. That's the ideal cut diamond. What?
Jared has five times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores, with thousands of loose diamonds and hundreds of settings to create your own one-of-a-kind ring.
That's an extraordinarily beautiful moment.
Yo, man, you crying?
No.
That's the power of selection. That's Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Water damage strikes fast. So do we. When you call the cleanup specialist at 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
Game number two of Capital One Bowl Week here in the capital of the Gem State, Idaho. The wonderful town of Boise, Idaho, on the blue turf, home of the Boise State Broncos. And the Humanitarian Bowl, the UDrove Humanitarian Bowl, as Chad Spann breaks his first big run of the day on the first play of the second quarter. The MAC Offensive Player of the Year.
And defensive end Chris Carter better be very careful today. You're going to see him outside lose leverage. Right tackle Keith Otis does just enough to contain, and that's all Spann needs.
Just enough was just a little bit of a grab of that jersey to start to get straight.
Hey, let him play in a bowl game, coach. You know
hard.
Let
I'll tell
guys
you what.
Play.
Those defensive players get frustrated when their jerseys get stretched needlessly.
24-yard pickup for the former walk-on Chad Spann, now senior scholarship performer. Harnish looks to throw. Harnish looking for more again. It's incomplete. Deesha Dunn had another chance at the interception.
Great job by Deesha Dunn. They ran a deep crossing route. He passed off one man, saw the other guy crossing, and stayed way deep. That's a veteran corner that sees the field.
Nice to have him back for Fresno State. Second team all WAC. Missed that Illinois game with a groin injury. And we saw earlier, right, the jump ball that Clark took advantage. That time he bodied him up, timed his jump better, and took away the would-be touchdown.
Fresno State is missing one defensive starter, Kyle Knox, among three players suspended by Pat Hill for the bowl game. On second down, it's Harnish on a draw. With blue turf in front of him, the second rushing touchdown of the season, of the game, for Chandler Harnish to give Northern Illinois the lead.
And right now, NIU is taking advantage of the pass rush of Fresno State. Obvious pass situation shows the pass set by the offensive line. and there's nobody there. They're running up the field, letting the quarterback go.
Northern Illinois going to try a PAT, but did you see Sean Plummer as well? The linebacker taking the place of Knox just got lost in his drop. No awareness of where the quarterback was.
Lomonski missed the last extra point kick. Fumbled hole there, but Harnish manages to put it down. The PAT is through, and the Huskies have a 13-7 lead on the Bulldogs. We are young! We are young! Engines never
gonna chase us down! We are... Drivers, let UDrove take the pain and chaos out of your record keeping and eliminate that paperwork mess. Using your smartphone, driver logs, inspection reports, proofs of delivery, and other paperwork headaches become a thing of the past. UDrove makes managing your business a breeze. To be competitive in the trucking industry, drivers and fleets are turning to UDrove. UDrove, we'll do the rest.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer.
It's our most wonderful line of the year. During the GMC holiday event, sign and drive a GMC Acadia for $384 per month with nothing due at signing. It's our best offer of the year.
This holiday, experience the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. The passion, the tradition, the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. Holiday gift collection at Macy's.
The road to the most college basketball begins with ESPN Full Court on DirecTV. Watch top-ranked teams from across the nation collide, no matter where you live. Get over 30 games per week of key rivalries and top conference action you can't see anywhere else. Every game is a home game with ESPN Full Court on DirecTV. Don't miss your chance to get a piece of the action. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit DirecTV.com/FullCourt.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
They are the best, and these. Here we go!
It's not in your mailbox.
Good morning!
It's not in that vending machine.
This is beyond nuts, boss. It gets better.
It's already in your hands. Why wait when you can rent the A-Team on DirecTV Cinema?
I love it when a plan comes together.
Movies start at Channel 125.
ESPN College Football, the UDrove Humanitarian Bowl, is brought to you by your friends at UDrove, the Capital One Venture Card, What's in Your Wallet, and Taco Bell. Think outside the bun.
If you're a fork lover, you like to strap on the feed bag, 13th Street Pub and Grill, a tremendous dinner they hosted us last night. Pork belly, tenderloin, New York strip loin, Agribeef, a family-owned company headquartered here in Boise. They produce Snake River Farms American Kobe beef. Woo-hoo.
It was so good. I've never turned away. I couldn't eat that much. It was so good and so much of it.
I was kind of disappointed, to be honest. Maybe the first time all year.
A challenge.
Yeah.
At the table. You won. You won the beef eating contest.
It was a tremendous meal. Burris is going to bring it out after all. 55-yard kick return last time. This time, only 17 as he brings it out of the end zone.
That was a great kickoff. That had great hang time and great depth. Probably should not have been taken out. But again, once you get a chance to take one back, you get a feeling, you know, it's hard to say, don't bring it out.
So Fresno State punt on the last drive, touchdown the first drive. Tom Matukiewicz, the interim head coach for Northern Illinois. Jerry Kill taking the Minnesota head coaching job. Dave Dorn will be the head coach at Northern Illinois, but he is not here in Boise. He will be joining us shortly.
And Robbie Rouse not in. Oh, he's in there. He is in there. He's just hitting that Q-tip.
I was wondering.
They're still trying to get the ball on the edge and take advantage of that speed and quickness on the outside.
Well, up here from the press box, Jeff Grady, offensive coordinator of Fresno State, sees what we see, and that's eight guys committed around that line of scrimmage. And when you get one-on-one outside, you've got to be committed to taking advantage of that.
And that's a form of the running game. That's just a long handoff when they throw it out there like that.
How about Colburn, 6-for-7. Last game against Illinois, 304 passing yards, 3 touchdowns, and a Fresno State win over the Illini to close out the regular season. A passing game opening up more in the last couple games for Fresno State. Bowman delivers again. Nice grab by A.J. Ellis out of the backfield, but the Huskies rally to the football, forcing third down.
And we talked about the fact that for us to watch and see if they substitute at running back when they're going to throw the ball or try to throw the swing pass where the running back will be involved in the passing game.
And there's our impact player, Chris Smith, very physical. One thing we've noticed here with Northern Illinois, they're willing to rush 4 guys because this defense on the back end, a defense that starts 7 seniors, is swarming to the football.
3-for-3 on third down. All 3 of those were to Jamal Hamler, who was at the bottom of your screen. Colburn looks that way again. Denied, so he slips away from the pressure. Dropped well short by Tyrone Clark and Devon Butler.
And a lot of players on the NIU sideline welcoming their players off the field. Offensive guys cheering on defensive guys and vice versa. They're very fired up right now.
Well, they follow the lead of their head coach. Again, I want to reiterate yesterday in our meeting, I can't remember ever feeling the excitement we felt yesterday. It was like Christmas for Matukiewicz to have this opportunity. He's just relishing in it.
Shapiro's last punt went only 20 yards. Tommy Davis back to return. He set up for the return on a wobbly kick. Davis has to slide to get it at the 47. Excellent field position for the Huskies. Capital One Bowl Week continues ESPN Wednesday night. The Utah Utes take on Kellen Moore and the Boise State Broncos in the Mako Bowl, Las Vegas. Capital One Bowl Week ESPN Wednesday. Game also available online at ESPN3.com and on your phone. Guys, what do we think of the Utah-Boise State matchup?
Well, Utah's been brilliant in bowls, 9 consecutive wins, but they better hope those 50-mile-an-hour gusts of winds that blew through Vegas last year in that game come back, because I don't see them slowing down Titus Young, Austin Pettis, and Kellen Moore in their last game together.
Boise's a great team and still smarting from not being in a BCS bowl game.
Harnish, who has 2 rushing touchdowns today, gets the carry again on first down to pick up 7, maybe 8 yards.
You know what I'd love to see here, Carter? As we talked about Harnish early in the game, sailing a couple passes, you want to settle a quarterback down, and a guy that can run it the way he can, call quarterback draws. Get him into the game physically. I mean, Fresno State doesn't have an answer right now for the QB run game.
Chad Spann picks up first down for the Huskies inside the 40. Quarterback Chandler Harnish is a guy who went through an amazing rehab, had a potentially career-ending knee injury. He decided not to have surgery, and here he is back on the field. He missed the first couple games of the season, but without the surgery, and what doctors thought was an injury that would end his career. Spann runs right into Logan Harrell on first down.
It seems like they're going up-tempo now. They wanted to change the tempo of the game, but I'm going to ask you, so you wanted your quarterback to get hit a little bit to get him in rhythm or to settle him down? Is that what
you're
saying?
Well, not necessarily the lefty on the other side, Colburn, and not necessarily with my 5'1", 40 speed, but when you can run like Harnish does, and he's their second leading rusher, and it's a real strength within their system, coach, yeah, I like settling him down through contact.
Harnish to throw on 2nd and 9. Moore wide open. Makes the defender miss to pick up a first down. Isaiah Green in coverage slipped just a little bit on the chilly blue turf here in Boise.
Too much cushion, man. Again, when you're off that far, again, just slightly late coming out of the break. And again, nice move to make him miss. Didn't have any problem with the turf right there.
Those yards after catch receivers, they just have that sense. He has no eye contact of where the corner is, but he feels him and makes the move off of it.
Green making just his 3rd career start, playing in place of the injured Jermaine Thomas. Spann lined up receiver on the near side. He'll be blocking for Harnish on another design. QB run, fumble. Harnish makes a nice play to knock it out of bounds, meaning the Huskies keep possession. Flag down. It's going to be an illegal batting. I said a nice play by Harnish, but the rule book says no.
Yeah, look at again where he's carrying that football. When you're running to your left, Got to put that in your outside hand, and you also can't bat the ball forward. I think that's what some of the conversation's about here.
Smart play, though. You don't want that ball sitting on the turf when you're on the ground. So you take you don't worry about the penalty there. You make sure that ball, either you get it or you get it out of bounds.
Illegal batting by offense, number 12. That's a 15-yard penalty. Also includes a loss of down. He's second down.
I'll tell you what, 15-yard penalty and loss of down, that's probably the most costly penalty in the books. You see right there, it's tough. He was right next to the sideline. If he just pushed it or tried to recover it, but he wanted to make sure that ball, as I said, got out of bounds. But now, I'll tell you what, you're way back there. This is second in a long, long ways.
So again, illegal batting is the call because of Harnish batting it out of bounds illegally. How about that?
Really well said.
Thank you.
Twice.
Making it second and 24. Now the play clock winding down. Harnish is going to take it on the draw again. Good block in the middle. Jacobs finally catches up with him.
So what do you do here, Coach? You've seen now a number of draws. What is the coaching point to your front seven?
Well, what you have to do is the rushers have to stay at the level of the quarterback. They can't run up the field. And they're using the aggressiveness of the Fresno State defensive line, their rush patterns, against them. And the other thing is the linebackers now have to stay a second longer on the run key instead of getting into their pass coverage lanes.
Third down. Pumps on the roll pass, nearly intercepted by Philip Thomas. It's incomplete.
Almost a cardinal mistake. He had the edge, but he chose to throw back across his body, which, tell me how tough that is running full speed.
Yeah, you can't do it. Your clock speeds up. You hear it over and over again that those safeties have such an advantage in the ground and the few bit of real estate that they've got to cover. Now, this is an interesting call. You've missed a PAT. You have to have some awareness here, possibly a fake field goal.
Would be a 45-yarder. Lomonski has missed three of his last five kicks. This one is away from 45, and this one is good, giving Northern Illinois a 9-point lead.
Could have been good from 60. He talked about the fact that the coach says he can kick down a door.
We'll visit with the next head coach of Northern Illinois, Dave Doran, when we return.
It's only the first quarter.
At United Heritage, we like to hear the sound of your dreams.
Come on.
With the Capital One Venture Card, we get double miles on every purchase. So we earned a holiday trip to the Big Apple twice as fast.
Dinner.
We get double miles every time we use our card. And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang. It's hard to beat double miles.
I want a mace, a sword, ow!
Get the Venture Card from Capital One and earn double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
I wonder what it can be.
What's in your wallet?
Taco Bell's $2 meal deal. Each with a Taco Bell original, Doritos chips, and a medium soda. Three items, $2. Now that's a deal.
So I buy a beefy five-layer burrito and drink, and you throw in the chips for free?
How about you just give me $2, and it's all free?
Let's do it.
Why pay more? Rated M for mature.
There's only one vehicle tough enough to play in this world. The 2011 Jeep Wrangler Call of Duty Black Ops Edition. With a redesigned interior, the new Jeep Wrangler remains one tough 4x4.
Here's to America's real working hands. They keep our country going strong with Irwin Vice Grip Tools. Like our Groove Lock pliers that adjust with the press of a button and never slip or pinch. Irwin Vice Grip, reach for greatness.
in beautiful Boise, Idaho. There is no Z. It is Boise, Idaho. The U-Drove Humanitarian Bowl, December 18th. It's opening day of the Capital One Bowl Week. You guys participated in bowl games, Brock, at the University of Washington, Mike, a lot of them at the University of Oregon. What do you think about playing a bowl game on December 18th?
I think it's actually awesome because you get to play in a bowl game, you have all the fun and enjoyment, all the swag, but you get to go home for Christmas, and you really get about a two-week break for coaches and players.
And players love it. I can't reiterate that enough. Everyone wants to talk playoffs. You know what? $500 for a kid in college and a new sweatshirt and hat. And we were in heaven when we got those goodie bags.
I can tell you this, it's only gotten better. Burse tiptoes to the 25.
Burse can't stop his feet, though. Again, he's got to hit that full speed. We call it blind faith for kickoff return. But, you know, one thing, it's up to $1,000 now because the bowl can give you $500 worth of gifts and the university can give you $500 worth of gifts if they choose to. It's a significant package. It's a lot of fun.
And we're happy to take whatever stakes are alive before us is our swag, right? First of four that we're going to have together, guys. Fresno State from the 25. This is Robbie Rouse. Mike, as you said, Northern Illinois not giving Robbie Rouse any room to work.
And I'm not sure he's totally healthy. He doesn't look, again, I think the ribs probably are more a problem than the hand because he just doesn't quite have the same burst and explosiveness we saw earlier in the season.
It's awfully tough. It is congested between the tackles. And right now, Northern Illinois is saying, okay, Fresno State, beat us with the pass because we're going to overload this box.
Wildcat formation with Burse taking the direct snap. Burse is going to keep it on the option. Picks up a couple to bring up third down and four.
You know, one of the things Jeff Gray, the offensive coordinator, talked about is the fact that they expected to have nine in the box, so they had to be ready to execute the basics of the pass game, anything one-on-one they could get.
And look at this, Coach. You have no Northern Illinois defender beyond 6 yards, and in fact, you got 8, 9 of them right around the line of scrimmage.
And they're daring you to throw outside or deep. And again, you have to be comfortable and confident throwing to the sideline.
And how much of that is because it's Isaiah Burse in there on a wildcat formation?
No question. I mean, but I'm talking about they're playing that fairly standard. Those safeties are down in the box.
Only one deep safety back for Northern Illinois now with Colburn in a QB on third down. Colburn, quick hitter, caught across the 40-yard line.
I like what Tom Matukiewicz told us. He said, I've got to take something away. When you look at a Fresno State team and a Pat Hill coach team, they strive for balance. They want to run it. Then it's play action pass. And then you're really chasing your tail. But when you can take one thing away, and they're solely bent here in this first half of taking away that run, you have an opportunity.
Coach Tuka is a linebacker coach. We're going to not let them run. We're taking the run away. They're going to have to beat us with the pass.
Out of the 22 personnel, Colburn wants to throw, but he's going to take a sack.
Hard to afford. You can't afford to do that. And again, that's a combination coverage sack and effort sack by the defensive line.
What did Jay Sovell, the defensive coordinator, tell us yesterday? When there was a tight end and two backs for Fresno State, what was coming? Will free safety, backside. They felt like there was a real advantage that they could squash that pocket from the backside when they had that personnel group to attack.
Jake Kaufman gets the sack, second of the day for the Husky defense. Second and 15, this is Rouse. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage, maybe, but third down and long coming up.
And Rouse just can't seem to get started. He's so dangerous in space, but right now they're diminishing, they're controlling that net around him and not letting him get any open field to run through.
I can't imagine how difficult it would be to play that position. This game's hard enough, and you've got to protect, you've got to catch passes, you've got to run, and you're doing it in essence with one hand this afternoon.
Broken bones in that left hand. He missed the last game with a rib injury. Still out there on third down, third and 11. Rouse out of the backfield. Colburn's going to find him. He makes the grab at the 50 and has another Fresno State first down, corralling the football with one good hand and one all wrapped up.
What club? What cat? Nothing like that. But I'll tell you what, it's a great job by the Fresno offensive line picking up the line stunt of NIU, allowing Colburn to get open down the field, step down, and then find the open receiver.
Well, that's been the difference here. That's what's keeping Fresno State alive. Northern Illinois is getting the Bulldogs into third downs, but on five different occasions now, Colburn's made plays through the air.
And notice Ryan Colburn took a little bit off that pass, too, to make sure that Rouse could handle it.
Colburn passing 5 for 5 on third downs for Fresno State.
Here it comes again. Look at the tight end two back.
Fresno State picks up the blitz. Colburn swings it to the outside. It's Hamler, makes the first defender miss. Cuts back. Hamler finally wrestled down to the 27.
And actually right there, NIU got what they wanted. They wanted to make sure that he didn't get his first read. They wanted to have that ball in the air for a long time. But again, lack of too tight a coverage there on Hamler on the outside resulted in a fairly easy catch.
When you run a comeback, you must help your quarterback out and come back to the football exactly as Hamler does.
Well, Colburn's legs were tied up too. He had no way to transfer his weight forward. That was thrown with all arm, 20 yards.
Hamler, 4 catches, 51 yards, and a touchdown. To throw again. Colburn has his man covered, so he will scramble out of bounds for a pickup of a few.
Colburn run out of bounds.
Sean Progar forces him out.
And that's nice awareness. That's a fifth-year senior. When you get down near this red zone, the last thing you want to do is try to force the issue.
No question. And again, he bought time, saw that it wasn't there, drifted out the side, but made positive yardage. And again, throwing on first down now, changing up some of the dynamics. I think that's important.
How about with all this blitz and pressure, how about a little screen pass?
That's been a staple they've lived by, made some big plays over the course, especially down here in the red zone.
On second down, Colburn on the slant, pass incomplete.
Ooh, a little collision. Oh. Fresno State fans yes. want pass interference, but that was two guys going for the ball. I don't think anybody stretched out the hand. There definitely was a collision, though, going to the football.
Patrick George in tight coverage.
You see the break on the ball right there. Normally, you might get that call. I'm surprised again, but two guys equally going for the ball.
No. Well, let me ask you, because you hear it said all the time, the defender has just as much right to the football, but he can't do it going through the receiver, can he?
Exactly right. And I think, again, the fact that they both took an angle to the ball was correct.
Bringing up third down. Remember, Colburn is perfect passing on third down. Looks to throw again. Now flushed out of the pocket. Colburn will be dropped from behind as Kaufman forces the fumble. Screaming in from Colburn's blind side. It's fumbled out of bounds. Fresno State keeps it, but a tremendous effort from Jake Kaufman.
Well, we highlighted him as an impact player, and that's an impossible job for Robbie Rouse with one hand to try to block their most productive D end, and that's relentlessness.
Kaufman, 26 years old. He decided to come back after he had already earned his Northern Illinois degree last year. One more season of football. This will be his final game as a Northern Illinois Husky. 46-yard field goal attempt coming from Kevin Gessling, a semifinalist for the Lou Groza Award. Boots this one through to make it 16-10. Points on the board for Fresno State on the field goal from Gessling.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 1st.
Sometimes it's not easy to find good talent for SportsCenter, which is why we brought in Les to help with recruiting.
And of course, you'll have full access to our state-of-the-art digital center. Best in the nation.
We pride ourselves in getting the best. Sometimes you just have to pull out all the stops.
Born to wear pinstripes, eh, Dad?
Oh, yeah.
John Anderson's just don't grow on trees. You got to go out and find them.
Do you see yourself sitting here in front of millions of sports fans?
Yes, sir.
Me too.
The contrast of infinite black. The clarity of fast-switching phosphors. The smoothness of 600 hertz. All come together to create what CNET calls the best picture quality of any 2010 TV. The Viera Full HD 3D TV from Panasonic. Get a bonus Avatar Blu-ray 3D disc from Best Buy when you buy a Viera 3D TV.
Are you ready for your talk, sir?
Just going over how GEICO helps people save in even more ways. With good driver discounts, multi-car discounts, defensive driver discounts.
You! Oh, don't act like you don't recognize me. Toledo? 03?
No, it's...
It's too late, Stanley.
Actually, miss, but my name's not Stanley.
Oh. Oh, I am so sorry. From behind, you look just like him. I'm just...
Well, I'd hate to be Stanley.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15%.
Welcome back to Boise, Idaho. The 2010 UDROVE Humanitarian Bowl. It's Northern Illinois leading Fresno State 16-10. Tom Matukiewicz, the interim head coach today in the bowl game for Northern Illinois. Dave Doran is the next head coach for the Northern Illinois Huskies. He joins us on the phone now. And Coach Doran, Madison, Wisconsin, is that correct?
Yes, it is.
So if let me know if I've missed any stops here, but Shawnee Mission Northwest High School, your alma mater Drake, USC, Montana, Kansas, Wisconsin, all as an assistant. What is it like now to be the head coach of a football bowl subdivision team?
Well, it's a dream come true. You know, it's been 16 years coming and a few stops along the way that you mentioned, and started out the high school level, worked my way up, and I'm very proud to be a Husky and watching these guys play the way they are right now.
What are you feeling right now as you're at home watching the team that you will lead here shortly?
Very proud. It is surreal, you know, because I was in the office all day today watching TCU tape and then get to come home and watch this. So it's a fun day, no doubt.
Coach, do you have your staff lined up for next year? Where are you with that?
I do have several of the guys locked in. Unfortunately, I can't announce them until this game's over. We're working through that with media, but I do have several of the guys, and they're excited. I'm getting text messages here left and right about certain players that they're going to coach. It's been fun.
What's standing out to you here in this first half with your soon-to-be team?
Well, they're playing smart. You know, they're not beating themselves. They're playing hard. The quarterback, obviously, Harness, has made some great plays on his feet. And it was fun watching Martell Moore there earlier jump up and get one. But I'll say I love watching their defensive guys fly around, particularly Jake Kaufman. I wish I had him back.
Well, Coach Doran, you are the new Northern Illinois head coach. You were also the defensive coordinator for the Wisconsin Badgers, getting ready for the Rose Bowl against TCU. How do you play both roles between now and the Rose Bowl?
Well, you know, being a coach, time management's one of the most important things in your job, and it's just a matter of shifting priorities. I would have been out recruiting for Wisconsin this week, and instead of doing that, you know, I'm just balancing my time between TCU and my role here with NIU.
Well, speaking of recruiting, how's that going? How's the reception out there for you?
It's been great. You know, I've gotten a lot of phone calls from high school coaches and, you know, the kids that were committed, getting in touch with them and introducing myself to them and their families. And I haven't hit the road yet for these guys, but everybody I've talked to has been receptive on the phone.
Well, Coach, thanks for joining us on the phone. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me, guys.
Best of luck.
Dave Doran, the new head coach for Northern Illinois and the defensive coordinator for the Wisconsin Badgers, who will meet TCU in the Rose Bowl. Arn is scrambling again on first down. And just like you thought, guys, I mean, the thoughts from Coach Doran were, boy, I wish I could have Patrick. Wish I could have, you know, these guys back. I mean, I wish I could have some of these Huskies on my team. Jake Kaufman, wish you could have him back for another year, and you know, evaluating as the game goes on.
And the other thing, he's probably evaluating some of the coaches and a lot of the players he's going to be coaching next year, but he's pretty happy right now because they're in the lead.
Pressure coming from the Bulldogs. Harness releases, completes on the outside. It's Martell Moore again. Moore dragged down near the 25.
Well, I really like this guy. We've seen a number of plays, and he is just a true sophomore outside. We've seen him elevate and go up and high point the football. We've seen him now on a couple occasions win. It's just a simple hitch route, but his athleticism a step ahead.
And he's got the respect of the corner. The corner's not going to close too quickly, which gives him space to make those moves.
Less than 2 minutes to go in the half. Northern Illinois, a six-point lead in the football, resting right on the 25-yard line.
I tell you what, this is a fast game between running the football and very few incompletions. They've run this clock pretty fast.
Short gain on first down for Chad Spann. So both of the star running backs in this game, Robbie Rouse and Chad Spann, held in check by the defense. Is that probably not a coincidence?
No, because these are both pretty good. Both teams run the football, so they know how to defend the run. But again, they've been vulnerable on the flanks. I think the question is whether Fresno starts calling timeouts now or just lets the clock run. And the more it goes, probably we're going to see them let this clock run.
Play fake. Got him for the touchdown. It's Kyle Spohr, the fullback, with his second touchdown grab of the year. 2 rushing touchdowns for Chandler Harnish today, and now 1 through the air.
Great job. Again, they double motioned their guy and got him up in the seam. They lost him in coverage with the play action fake.
Klamovsky for the PAT, 1 miss today, 1 make. They get 2 makes. Touchdown Huskies, a 13-point edge on the Bulldogs.
Trucking Association salutes the women behind the wheel.
It's Red Lobster's ultimate surf and turf event with 3 seafood and steak combinations all under $20, like succulent lobster and wood-grilled sirloin or new Chardonnay shrimp and sirloin. End soon at Red Lobster.
We talk about traditions. We talk about
the big turkey and the big pernil.
I call Europe a lot, Italy, Spain.
I'm in touch with old friends.
My mom and I are very chatty.
That's one of the cool things with Vonage. It's one set price, unlimited calling, and that no surprises at the end of the month.
No annual contract? I mean, that's even better.
Once you try it, you're going to stick with it.
I'm Judy Compress, and this was my last bill before I switched to Vonage.
This holiday, switch your home phone to Vonage and get unlimited domestic and international calling now with no annual contract.
Is she awake?
Just fell asleep. Where are you up? It's 2 a.m.
It's not just 2 a.m. It's 2 a.m. Christmas morning. It's our first Christmas as a family. I couldn't wait.
Levion Jewelry, featuring Levion Chocolate Diamonds. Levion, one more reason Kay is the number one jewelry store in America.
You think she'll remember this Christmas?
I know I will.
Every kiss begins with K.
Rated M for mature.
There's only one vehicle tough enough to play in this world. The 2011 Jeep Wrangler Call of Duty Black Ops Edition. With a redesigned interior, the new Jeep Wrangler remains one tough 4x4.
A million miles matters, and to prove it, we've given Karen an ordinary GPS and Phil a TomTom GPS with a million more miles of road. Do drivers prefer more miles? We're about to find out.
Not again.
Chandler Harnish has his first passing touchdown of the game, and Northern Illinois has a 13-point lead. Let's go back to the touchdown pass.
And the Huskies do a couple things here. Number one, they go unbalanced. Number two, they bring a motion, and you can see it completely confuse Fresno State and 2 guys. That's Phillip Thomas, and that's your veteran safety. He opens up backwards. That means Thomas has to get depth underneath both of those guys, both your cap, you know, your leadership on the back end, clearly in the wrong.
And there's no eligible receiver on that side, so he's got to come over and key play side, front side.
And we saw Pat Hill during that break call that defense over to talk not just about the schematics, but some of the energy as well. They're just not tackling well in the open field.
Four straight scoring drives for Northern Illinois. Burst takes an E. We check in with Chris Fowler.
Ricardo, the cars.com halftime report is coming up. Todd McShay joins me. Highlights of BYU's bowl win. Todd will tell you about his three favorite December bowl matchups and NBA news, a trading flurry involving the Orlando Magic. So, cars.com halftime report just minutes away from the studio. See you back.
All right, Chris, we are speeding through the first half here at Broncos Stadium in Boise, Idaho. 57 seconds remain. Fresno State from the WAC against Northern Illinois from the MAC. Carter Blackburn with Mike Bellotti, Brock Heward, and Shelly Smith. Colburn to throw on first down, finds a Hamler again for a pickup of 8.
Again, 3 timeouts available, and if you don't get a first down to get out of bounds, you got to think about using it now.
In the hurry up, clock rolling under 40 seconds now. Colburn to the air again. It's complete on the outside. The clock will stop temporarily on the first down as A.J. Johnson makes the grab.
And this is where you're with Colburn. You have the advantage with the clock stopping. Make sure you get everybody up and set when they restart that clock, not to burn any seconds.
You also have a kicker who's made a 58-yarder in his career.
There's 5, 6, 7. Those are all wasted critical errors.
So under 20 seconds as Colburn drops, has to heave it long. It is caught inside the 40. Nice catch by A.J. Johnson, the redshirt freshman. Had only 17 catches all season. He has made great back-to-back plays.
Seen a number of times Colburn this afternoon trusting his receivers in one-on-one situations with the corner's back turned to him to make the play. But I can't say it enough, those 7 seconds, instead of snapping that ball at 30 and the foot's clearly in and has possession, take the time out there, Mike. Why waste the 7 seconds at the line of scrimmage? Because now you're really only left with a chance for maybe 2 plays.
I agree. They have 2 timeouts left. They should have used them. They would have saved 15 to 18 seconds, which is crucial right now. One of the other things you have to get as a defender, if you're a man, is a ball call to alert you to the fact that the ball's in the air. That defensive back just continued to watch. It was Chris Smith, I believe, the receiver all the way, never got any type of a cue from any teammate that the ball was in the air coming to his man.
You are within the field goal range of Kevin Gessling, who has the school record at 58. That was 2 years ago. His season long is 50.
In the NIU secondary, they're tackle him inbounds, nothing over your head.
15 seconds before the half. Colburn, long drop, pressure. Colburn slips out of it, heaves the football, but no gain on the play. 6 seconds, 5 seconds, timeout granted with 5 seconds after the catch by Saunders. Monday night on the frozen tundra of TCF Bank Stadium. NFC North rivals Chicago and Minnesota meet. Vikings without Brett Favre. ESPN's Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. Coverage begins 7 Eastern. Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's.
It really will be the frozen tundra. I heard they were paying, offering jobs $10 or $11 an hour to come shovel snow.
Mm-hmm.
We could all pick up a little extra work if we wanted.
And they actually had winterized that stadium at the University of Minnesota, and now they had to go back, clear the pipes, warm everything back up, as you said, get everyone to clear the snow. I'm going to guess it'll be a little bit chilly.
It's
up
a
there
night game in December.
A Monday night game of Minnesota.
Outdoors. The home field of the University of Minnesota. 1 second put back on the clock here, so officially 6 before the half. Fresno State still has 1 timeout.
And it's hard to get in 2 plays in 6 seconds, guys, I'll tell you.
So Colburn on second down. Complete. Hamler goes down immediately. Now the clock will be stopped temporarily on the moving of the chains. Pat Hill is going to use his final timeout. 2 seconds left to get a little bit closer for Kevin Gessling.
That was great execution, because obviously he could not have continued to run very much longer. Had to get down and then immediately call timeout, which the coach can do to the sideline official, which makes it so much easier now.
That's exactly right. Very well done. Maybe you cost yourself a few seconds early in the drive, but good coaching there on the sidelines to make everybody aware of the situation.
...43-yard attempt coming. Timeout, Northern
First
Illinois.
First charge timeout, Northern Illinois. 30-second charge timeout.
And we're going to ice the kicker. And the snow's not here, but they're going to try to ice the kicker anyway.
And I'm glad you mentioned the snow, Mike. We were projected for a few inches of snow today in Boise, but thankfully it has held off. Cold, but...
You know,
good game conditions.
Yeah,
otherwise.
And one of the rules they're talking about changing is the ability to call these timeouts like this. And I'm not sure. As a coach, I want the ability to do that. I don't know what you think.
Three times?
Yeah. If I got three timeouts, I mean, come on. Speaking of, there it is. New year, new rules. Make
ESPN,
the game
the
better.
Magazine on newsstands now. Kessling, 43-yard attempts, but first a timeout. And Kessling with a. Low tap for Chris Smith, who was coming off the edge.
30-second charge timeout.
He wanted to prove he's a football player, not just a kicker.
Well, how about Tom Matukowicz not afraid to call the timeout and attempt to ice the kicker? The interim head coach. Well, new year, new rules. A creative look at rules in sports. Plus a story on the seven best rule changes ever, including the forward pass in football.
Yeah, that's kind of a critical one.
It wasn't in my lifetime, by the way. I want to let you know that. So. It might have been in my lifetime. I'm not sure.
Now, I will say, if I'm Coach Matukowicz and Pat Hill necessarily would do the same thing, yeah, I'm taking all of these timeouts. But if you're going to make a rule change, this is one that I'd like to see go away.
Snap down. Gessling's 43-yard kick is no good.
And that's tough because Gessling has been money this year. He's a great kicker and very accurate.
Northern Illinois takes a 13-point edge to halftime against Fresno State here in Boise, Idaho, the 2010 Udrove Humanitarian Bowl. Tom Matukowicz, the interim head coach for Northern Illinois, had three goals for his team. It was celebrate the season, get a school record 11th win, and have fun with the bowl experience here in Boise. I think they are well on their way to accomplishing all three.
They are, and they're having a chalk talk right now on the sideline, not in the locker room, but right there, talking about what you feel right now, but you got to keep it going. This is only halfway through. You get a chance to talk to him here, coach, here very quickly.
Tom Matukowicz, who was the linebackers coach before Jerry Kill took the Minnesota head coaching job, both coordinators with him. So Matukowicz, the head coach for a day. He will stay in Northern Illinois as part of the new staff under Dave Doran. Let's check in with Shelley Smith.
All right, Ice, the kicker worked. How did you think that was going to play out?
Well, we had a last-second field goal block where we sub a lot of people out. So we act like we're just going, and then the last time out, we subbed everybody out and went all in. Worked out for us.
How's it been this first half being the head coach? So far, so good, huh?
I tell you what, the other thing about those straight timeouts, if I can make this thing last longer, I'm going to do it now. I don't know if I'll ever get my opportunity, but I'm having a good time.
All right, and why is your quarterback? I know he's a great rusher, but why has he been so effective against this defense?
He's got balance. I mean, that's the thing. Which do you stop? I mean, he can run it. He can throw it. We got good receivers, and right now he's kind of taking what they're giving us.
Great. Thanks so much.
Undefeated in halftime interviews, walking off the field, Tom Matukowicz. His team up 13. Now we send you to the studio for the Cars.com halftime report. Chris Fowler.
Carter, thank you. This is the Cars.com halftime report. Todd McShay alongside. We've been starting from interim coach Matukowicz, who is getting his one chance to lead a team. Todd, and also for a conference in the MAC that's lost 14 out of the last 15 bowl games. Completely baffling that Fresno defense at halftime.
It really is. I mean, Chandler Harnish, the quarterback for Northern Illinois, has done a great job in terms of taking what the defense is giving him. As you heard Coach talking about, running the ball when the defense has backed off and turned its back to him in man-to-man coverage, throwing the ball efficiently in this game. The two rushing touchdowns really have been a big difference. Been impressed with Harnish.
283 total offense for NIU in the first half. That Fresno defense gets in the blue rug and they get freaked out. They give up 51 points to the Broncos earlier this season. And Ryan Colburn, efficient, 15 of 17, but not a lot of productivity.
Now, if Fresno State's going to come back in the second half, he's got to drive the ball down the field. You see, he has been efficient, Chris. He's thrown very accurately underneath, done a nice job, showed off his arm strength on outside the perimeter, but they, as a team, the Bulldogs have got to be able to throw the ball vertically and make some plays in the deep passing game. They also could use a little bit of a run game as well. I mean, it has been really tough sledding in the rushing attack for Fresno State. I think that's been the biggest difference, is that Northern Illinois can run the ball. Fresno State has not been able to.
Well, the bowl season got underway earlier this afternoon in New Mexico. A couple of 6-6 teams, and BYU for once not in Las Vegas for the first time after 5 straight years. They're taking on UTEP, and Jay Heaps, the freshman quarterback, Todd, a guy got up to a very slow start this season, but a strong finish as the Cougars win 5 of 6, and there's Heaps with a touchdown pass to Cody Hoffman at a huge game.
It was so in control, and Hoffman, just a freshman as well. So you're talking about two freshmen, a great battery for years to come, it looks like, at BYU.
Hoffman, 8 for 137 and 3 touchdowns, and Heaps, New Mexico Bowl record, 4 touchdown passes, 25 of 34. So BYU, strong finish of the season. What about looking forward to 2011?
Well, I think we've gotten a sneak peek of this combination and also the quarterback, Heaps. Sometimes taking a step away, self-evaluating, and then coming out and playing a bowl game like this is a huge advantage for a young quarterback, and Heaps clearly took advantage of it.
Good start for the Mountain West. And you may not realize this, folks, but 2 of the last 3 years, the Mountain West has had the best bowl record of any conference. The Bowl Challenge Cup winners last year and in the 2007-2008 bowl season. And you got Utah, Boise State, obviously the Utes who are a big underdog, but San Diego State, Air Force, and of course TCU against Wisconsin in the Rose Bowl. So Mountain West off to a good start. They typically have some good matchups, but it's a strong statement. Coming up, Todd, we'll take a look ahead at the bowl matchups in December, why Missouri-Iowa intrigues him. That's straight ahead on the cars.com halftime report.
Are you a mobile professional who wants to eliminate the hassle of tracking expenses and mileage? With UDrove Professional, you can. Using the GPS and camera capabilities of your smartphone, UDrove automates the management of your receipts and mileage log. End-of-the-month expense reports become a thing of the past, as UDrove captures this information in real time. Save time and be more productive with UDrove Professional. UDrove, we'll do the rest.
You like who you are, the man you've become. And you learn something along the way about the world and yourself. This is the age of knowing what you're made of and knowing how to get things done. So why would you let something like erectile dysfunction get in your way? Isn't it time you talk to your doctor about Viagra? 20 million men already have. With every age comes responsibility. Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Viagra if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Side effects may include headache, flushing, upset stomach, and abnormal vision. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. Stop taking Viagra and call your doctor right away if you experience a sudden decrease or loss in vision or hearing. You didn't get to this age by having things handed to you. This is the age of taking action. Viagra. Talk to your doctor. See if America's most prescribed ED treatment is right for you.
People choose 5-Hour Energy over 7 million times a week for lots of reasons. It's a nutritional supplement that really works. Its key ingredients can also be found in everyday foods like avocado, broccoli, bananas, or already in you. It contains about as much caffeine as a cup of the leading premium coffee, 0 sugar, 4 calories. What's going to be your reason for choosing 5-Hour Energy? Its effectiveness? Its beneficial ingredients? There's only one way to know. Try it today.
Sometimes it's easier for everybody to get together when they get away. Along the way, you can count on Valero being there with everything you need to get you where you want to be. And as you travel, open your eyes and see why they call it America the Beautiful.
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
And this canine battle, the Huskies have lead over the Bulldogs, and Chandler Harnish, more than 230 total yards and 3 total touchdowns for the NIU quarterback. 23-10 is the score. Coming up on opening night of bowl season 2010, the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. It's Ohio U out of the MAC, an 8-4 team against Troy, perennial powers in the Sun Belt. Ohio uses the pistol formation. They closed pretty strong. They won 7 of the last 8 games. Troy, of course, the spread passing attack. 9 o'clock Eastern time from the Superdome. Troy has a slot receiver, a wildcat quarterback to keep an eye on.
Jarrell Jernigan, don't miss him. The number one rated wide receiver on my board in terms of the seniors. Could be a second round draft pick. He does it all. I mean, he's a kick returner. He runs the football, as Chris alluded to. They'll put him in the wildcat. He'll be the trigger man of that package and also a slot receiver that can get down the field, make some big plays.
So Troy, Ohio, game number 3 on the opening day of bowl season. Let's look ahead. Todd, the December games that intrigue you. Missouri, Iowa. It's intriguing to me who's going to show up and play offense for the Hawkeyes. So many off the field issues.
So many of them. Ricky Stanzi, quarterback for Iowa. Does he have enough weapons around him? But I think it's the quarterback battle between Stanzi and Blaine Gabbert. Gabbert, I believe, is the second best quarterback prospect for this year's NFL, or next year's NFL draft, 2011. Should all of the underclassmen come out, should be very interesting to see which quarterback can step up and have a bigger game.
Steve Spurrier against his old rivals, the Seminoles.
And two very good teams coming off of tough losses in their respective conference games. Will Christian Ponder play at quarterback? I think that's a big question. And obviously, this defense for Florida State going up against the South Carolina offense, you've got the Noles number 2 in sacks going up against Steven Garcia. So it could be Ponder versus Garcia, an interesting quarterback.
Yeah, we hope Ponder's healthy and ready to go for that game.
Right.
Oklahoma State's offense against Arizona's defense in the Alamo Bowl.
Well, I know Mike Stoops, the head coach of Arizona, is hoping his defense can take this time off to lick some wounds and get ready. They gave up an average of 36 points in the last 4 games, all losses, going up against this vaunted Oklahoma State passing attack with Brandon Weeden, the quarterback, and throwing to one of the best in the business, Justin Blackman. It's going to be a very high-powered offensive affair, I think, both these teams. Over 700 yards probably in passing between these two quarterbacks, Nick Foles and Weeden.
That will be a fun one to watch. You know that Mike Stoops is going to talk to big brother Bob, of course, very familiar with that Oklahoma State program down there. Well, every sport has its rivalries. You know them. Division III also has its version. And coming up, we'll show you Wisconsin-Whitewater versus Mount Union, which does take its place among Lakers, Celtics, Yankees, Red Sox. For you D3 fans, you know what I'm talking about.
From an early age, Timothy Richmond understood that with knowledge comes confidence. In junior high, while abroad, he explained how jellyfish stings can be neutralized with vinegar. In perfect Italian. As an adult, Timothy's knowledge of storm cells and tornadoes saved the Newberry Prep cheerleading squad. But when it came time to buy a new car, he was just as nervous as the rest of us. So Timothy got his knowledge at Cars.com, regained his confidence, and got the perfect car at the perfect price.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake. You will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Fresno State celebrating 100 years of student success, academic excellence, pride in spirit. Building bright futures. A century of excellence.
Welcome back to the Cars.com Halftime Report. The Rose, Fiesta, Orange, Sugar, and the Tostitos BCS National Championship Game. ESPN, the BCS lives here.
Some good matchups. Dying to see Ryan Mallett, that Arkansas offense against the Ohio State defense in the All-State Sugar Bowl. Of course, TCU's big chance, their first Rose Bowl against Wisconsin.
Connecticut, huge underdogs against an Oklahoma team that struggled in BCS bowl games, and of course the BCS national championship game. A lot of time to talk about that high-scoring affair before it unfolds. How about the sixth straight year that Wisconsin Whitewater, those guys, take on Mount Union for the Division III championship, the Stag Bowl in snowy Virginia. Matthew Piloto goes deep. Cecil Shorts comes up with it. Purple Raiders up 21-10. But with Whitewater, defending champs will rally furiously here.
Runs a 4.36 in the 40, by the way, Cecil Shorts.
That's fast in any division.
There you go.
Lee Brecky goes deep. Tyler Huber in the end zone. This became a defensive struggle in the second half. Whitewater clinging to a three-point lead until Lavelle Coppage would get loose. A 71-yard touchdown finish with 2.99.
Oof. Hand him the MVP award now.
And Mount Union is the power in this division, but Whitewater, the growing dynasty. They've won three out of the last 4 years. Georgia Southern and Delaware semifinals in 1AA or FCS. And Pat Devlin, the former Penn State quarterback, had a nice game. A couple of touchdown passes for the Blue Hens here.
Showing his accuracy, very efficient as a quarterback in this game. Really had a good senior season. Looks to be the next drafted quarterback after Joe Flacco from Delaware.
So he's a draft pick. Devlin?
I think mid-fourth, fifth round at the worst.
And Delaware into the championship game, a 17-point win over Georgia Southern. Coming up, highlights from college basketball, number 3 Kansas in action, and NBA news also.
Chicken tenders, new at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's.
When an industry leader like Sony offers special deals on their high quality products, they move pretty quickly. So Peyton and I stop by to help out.
Back. 40.
Save more than $800 when you buy a Sony Home Entertainment package with a 3D Blu-ray disc player. Enjoy HD movies, even in 3D. Visit a participating retailer for details.
We're off to a good start. We're sending a lot of product out. Got a lot of work to do. We need a little more production out of you.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm not from around here. Do you think maybe later we can...
No.
There's a better way to fight flakes. New Garnier Fructis Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. Fights flakes for 48 hours, guaranteed.
Right now, the NCAA is building over 400,000 future professionals. And most of us will go pro in something other than sports.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
That's a plan.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any 4 movies between now and the end of the year. Movies like Night and Day.
It's a beautiful dress.
Inception.
I know how to search your mind and find your secrets.
The A-Team.
It gets better.
The Town.
I want to talk to you about your abduction.
This month, order any 4 movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, starting at channel 125.
There's a very important lesson to be learned from all this. Trust no one.
I know exactly what I'm doing. This is what it takes.
We're partners making something absolutely beautiful.
Damages premieres January 5th, channel 101, only on DirecTV.
Well, Josh Selby making his debut after a 9-game suspension to start the season. How about this? Welcome to college basketball. Down 2, buries the 3-pointer with 30 seconds to go. Kansas up by 1 over USC. The inbounds pass, Fontaine's heel on the sideline. You see it? Correct call, and Kansas holds on at home for a two-point win. NBA news, active. Rashard Lewis traded to the Wizards for Gilbert Arenas as the Magic slump combined with the Heat's hot streak made them think they had to make some quick moves. A six-player deal with the Suns, including a first-round draft pick and some cash as they trade away the troubled Vince Carter and get Turkoglu and a couple of other guys. Division two, Delta State and Minnesota Duluth. The national championship on the line, fourth quarter, 17-point tie. Micah Davis overthrown. Cody Ike picks it off, returns it 20 yards. On the next drive, 3 seconds to go. Minnesota Duluth, a hockey power, lines up for the field goal. David Nadeau. From 32 yards, a walk-off field goal barely curls it inside the upright. Does it get better than a walk-off field goal to win a national championship? That's what it's all about. All right, we'll see if NIU can keep it going. Up 23-10, Harnish running, throwing, and leading the Huskies to a 13-point lead over the Bulldogs. Back to Boise after this.
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
From an early age, Timothy Richmond understood that with knowledge comes confidence. In junior high, while abroad, he explained how jellyfish stings can be neutralized with vinegar.
Aceto alevia dolore.
In perfect Italian. As an adult, Timothy's knowledge of storm cells and tornadoes saved the Newbury Prep cheerleading squad. But when it came time to buy a new car, he was just as nervous as the rest of us. So Timothy got his knowledge at Cars.com, regained his confidence, and got the perfect car at the perfect price.
Good for 23 yards.
Hey, you went to Jared.
That's a peerless diamond. The ideal, ideal cut diamond. What?
If you want to create your own one-of-a-kind ring, get to Jared this Friday through Sunday, because you can receive Get Set and Diamonds rewards up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds and hundreds of settings. Get up to a $1,000 reward this Friday through Sunday at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Hey, boss. Do we have Aflac?
Nah, we have something else.
But if you're hurt and miss work, does it pay cash like Aflac does?
Nah.
Or let you spend it any way you want, like for gas and groceries?
Nah.
Or help with everyday bills like Aflac does?
Nah.
There's Aflac and there's everything else. Visit Aflac.com for an agent or quote.
Aflac!
We talk about traditions. We talk about
the big turkey and the big pernil.
I call Europe a lot, Italy, Spain.
I'm in touch with old friends.
My mom and I are very chatty.
That's one of the cool things with Vonage. It's one set price, unlimited calling, and no surprises at the end of the month.
No annual contract? I mean, that's even better.
Once you try it, you're going to stick with it.
I'm Judy Compress, and this was my last bill before I switched to Vonage.
This holiday, switch your home phone to Vonage and get unlimited domestic and international calling, now with no annual contract.
Idaho, the Udrove Humanitarian Bowl getting set for second half action. It's a 23-10 lead for Northern Illinois from the MAC over Fresno State from the WAC. Carter Blackburn with former Oregon head coach Mike Bellotti, Oregon's winningest head coach Mike Bellotti, Brock Heward, former All-Pac-10 quarterback at the University of Washington. And how about Tom Lutkiewicz going off at the half saying, if I could use my timeouts to make this last longer, I would. Clearly, he's enjoying it. Clearing the Husky, the Huskies enjoying their first half of football here in Boise.
He's enjoying it. He wants it to last. He had a team meeting before they left the field just to remind everybody how they feel right now, make sure they feel that way at the end of the game. Props in my mind to Robert Reeves, the offensive coordinator. He is calling plays. He's keeping Fresno State off balance, using their aggressiveness in the pass rush against them with the draws to Chandler Harnish.
And props on my end to the players, understanding amidst all the adversity and the dysfunction and the mess it really has been the last 2 weeks, understanding it's us. We are the players that can control this. And even going down early, 7-0, they responded the right way.
Well, Tom Lutkiewicz said this story will be written one of two ways. This team went through a lot in 2 weeks, a disappointing loss in the MAC championship game, a chance to win their first MAC title in 27 years. Slips away, Miami wins it, Jerry Kill and both coordinators off to the University of Minnesota. He said the end of the story will either be Northern Illinois came together through adversity and closed down a school record 11-win season, or we fell apart and didn't finish the job. It's halftime right now. We're just kicking off the second half, but Northern Illinois so far a 13-point lead, showing, as you said, Brock, coming together. Kickoff rolled by Klamovsky down inside the five, where it's scooped up by Slocum, and he will be dropped inside the 10. Let's check in with Shelly Smith.
Coach, you were absolutely right. Pat Hill said they were caught off guard. They expected a rushing offense. They didn't necessarily expect the quarterback to be running. He said, if we do not find some way to pressure him, we will not win this game. He said, Robbie Rouse is fine. Offense is not the problem. We're going to change some things up, make some switches defensively and personnel, but we've got to find a way to slow him down.
Difficult field position for Pat Hill and Fresno State on the opening drive of this second half. They get it at the 9. Colbert, quick drop, flings it outside. It's to Hamler again. Jamel Hamler has a first down across the 25. Flags down.
Late flag.
Activity on the sideline.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a hit out of bounds. Remember we drew up in the first half that blitz away from the two back and tight end, and there you see an immediate adjustment by Fresno State saying we're going to go quick game to combat that.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, number 25, defense, 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's Tracy Wilson, a safety who's coming back from injury for Northern Illinois. Isn't that tough to judge as a judge as a defensive player, whether the offensive player is out of bounds or not?
It is, and he's one of their best. In fact, the coaches feel he is their best defensive player. They've missed him. But again, when you get back, you're a little rusty on the timing of it. He wanted to make a big statement there, unfortunately got the penalty.
And Handler's still on the Fresno State sidelines after taking that hit. 18-yard catch, 15-yard penalty. That bad field position erased in a hurry. How about Rouse putting down the club hand to keep his feet? He loses two on the play anyway.
And you're going to see more throws in the flat, not only because of the zone blitz, but the 9-man box means the corners are on an island out there. And again, they're doing a great job of stopping the run inside. When a back has to change direction in the backfield to stop his momentum, it's not good for your running game.
And how about 5 Huskies around the football pursuing as well?
Colburn passing on second down, incomplete. Chris Smith, the first team All-MAC cornerback, comes up to disrupt the play.
Great break on the ball. He had off coverage to begin with. You saw the quarterback check, knew he was going there. As soon as he put his foot down, Chris Smith just burst on the ball and disrupted the route.
That's right. That's a senior, one of our impact players, Chris Smith, realizing if there's a check with me at the line of scrimmage, there's an audible, I've got to be aware of quick game, because more often than not, quarterbacks like to get the ball out of their hand, and he jumped the route.
Forcing Fresno State into 3rd and 12. Colburn pumps back over the middle, incomplete, intended for Saunders. As the rain begins to fall here in Boise.
A couple of few incompletions. He was 15 out of 17 in the first half. Very, very accurate. But again, one pass drop there. One, that was one of those, do you settle in the zone? Do you keep running? And the quarterback was uncertain.
So the Northern Illinois defense is up with a stop to begin the second half. Shapiro. Back to punt. Nearly got it. Shapiro gets it off. Davis back all the way to the 17. Fair catch called for. Tonight's storyline brought to you by Kay Jewelers. It was on the opening drive that Northern Illinois failed on a fourth down conversion. Next four drives, 23 points. Just a missed PAT, the only notch offensively against Northern Illinois. And then Ryan Colburn, 5 of 6 on third down and a touchdown in the first half.
And really give some credit to Chandler Harnish. As Shelley was saying downstairs, how about 220 plus yards of total offense, 60 on the ground. He was efficient through the air. Really found his game as that first half evolved.
Northern Illinois' first possession of the second half. First and 10, pump fake. Harnish comes back the other way. Caught out of the backfield. It's Jason Shepler, the tight end, making just his 8th catch of the season.
This is what Pat Hill and Randy Stewart were afraid of for Fresno State, that Harnish could not only run the football, he's already shown he can do that, but he's a very accurate passer and he sees the field well. He's making great decisions.
But you have been impressed with this first-time play caller with the innovation on offense.
No, they're doing a great job. They're taking again what Fresno does best and working, have it work against them. So that's what you'd like to do as a play caller, is negate what they do best.
From the 26, Harnish is going to give it to Spann. Nothing doing for the MAC Offensive Player of the Year, Chad Spann. So only 9 carries. If he picks up maybe 3 there, that gives Spann 55 yards. So held in check just like Miami did. Held him to just 57 yards in the MAC Championship game loss.
See the conversation there with Hamler. They can't afford, Fresno State cannot afford to lose him. He was the player hit late out of bounds. Coach is talking to him, imperative that he finds himself back in this game.
Harnish rolling on 2nd and 8. He's going to keep it. To bring up 3rd down, and here's that word again, manageable.
If you're going to face one of the best sack teams in the nation, I think Fresno State has 37 sacks on the season, 2 of the leading sackers in the nation. What you do is you turn that against them. You say, come after us. We're going to run the quarterback draw. They got away with a hold right there, but again, that happens in the pile. The quarterback is making them pay, and the play caller right now is making them pay.
We had Illinois a couple weeks ago, and Chris Carter devastated that front 7, and today, be it through maybe a couple holding calls or getting away with it, Northern Illinois containing the impact player for Fresno State.
On 3rd and 5, a Harnish looking long. What a play to come back to the football by Willie Clark. Manages to haul it down at the 36.
And once again, 2 DBs in the area, not knowing the ball's thrown, never finding the football, so the receiver's allowed to, right there, you just destroy that. You blow that up, because even if you get a penalty, it's better than having that type of gain down the field.
Yeah, with 2 guys, you would expect that ball call that you referred to earlier. Sometimes when you're on the opponent's sideline, you're obviously not going to get it. In that situation, you got to have your safety calling out to you, ball, ball, ball.
You're right. The safety over the top has to make that call, because he should be playing it from a position where he can see the ball being thrown.
39-yard pickup makes it 1st and 10 from the 26. Wide receiver toss off the hands of the intended receiver. It was Palmer throwing, intended for Landon Cox.
Love that call. You're in that part of the field where you can be aggressive. It's 1st down. Just a little too much pressure. I still got to find a way to bring that one in.
Philip Thomas created, again, stopped that play from happening by beating the block, putting the pressure. You're right, ball should have been still been caught, but great job by Philip Thomas rallying to the ball.
And if you're Landon Cox, you got to know, I've got a running back throwing this. It's not going to be with the precision from my quarterback. You've got to be prepared to come back to the football.
On his hands off, at 2nd and 10, Spann picks up a couple yards, and that's it. Forward progress will give him 2.
Well, I'll tell you my coaching point, if I'm Pat Hill defensively, and I've seen Chandler Harnish run the way he has, how many hits have we seen on him? How many times have we seen violent blows on the quarterback? If you're going to run quarterback draw within this front 7, and that's Travis Brown, that's Logan Harrell, it's Chris Carter, you better severely punish the quarterback every time he runs.
And Coach Matukowicz said he's got great balance and vision. That's why he's not getting hit like that. He's able to set up some blocks and make people miss.
Fresno State needing a stop on 3rd and 8. Harnish looking to the end zone. It's incomplete. LJ Jones in coverage. Perez Ashford, the intended receiver.
Again, Chris Carter continuing rush, but getting a lot of attention from the NIU offensive line. Difficult for him to make some plays today so far.
Well, you said he made it from 65 last time, Coach. I think we're going to get a chance to see it from 51 here.
Well, he's got a strong leg. Literally, Coach Matukowicz said he could kick down this door, and it was a big door. He's got a strong leg. He's just never sure exactly where it's going
to
go.
Planned to be a scholarship soccer player at Vanderbilt, and they cut their program. So he walked on at Illinois, and now in law school, walking on at Northern Illinois. Michael Klimovsky's 51-yard attempt is easily good.
Another 60-yarder at least.
Klimovsky boots it through. First points of the second half give the Huskies a 16-point lead in Boise.
Today's economy depends on the $660 billion trucking industry, and truck drivers depend on Udrove. Trucks bring life's essentials, from hauling equipment to football games to bringing snacks and drinks for your tailgate party. To remain competitive, trucking companies are lowering costs and advancing productivity with Udrove. By eliminating paperwork, Udrove is helping to make the trucking industry more efficient. Udrove, we'll do the rest.
Water damage strikes fast. So do we. When you call the cleanup specialist at 1-800-SERV-PRO.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
These Northern Illinois fans who traveled to Boise have witnessed Humanitarian Bowl history. The longest kick, a 51-yarder from Michael Klimovsky. That is the longest field goal in Humanitarian Bowl, now the Udrove Humanitarian Bowl
and
history.
I think Jake Kaufman has tied the record for sacks in a game, correct?
And I think they're a lot warmer here tonight than they would be if they were back home in DeKalb.
Plus about 45 degrees, I think.
Well, it's raining now, but it was a beautiful sunny day the last couple of days. Northern Illinois has been here since Tuesday, as has Fresno State. Touchback on the kickoff from Klimovsky. Tuesday night, Capitol Bowl week continues. Southern Mississippi with their potent offensive attack against the stout Louisville defense. It's Capitol One Bowl Week, ESPN Tuesday, 8 Eastern.
And if you like Chandler Harnish tonight, you're going to like quarterback Austin Davis for Southern Miss. He's why they're scoring 37 points a game. A dual threat himself, and it gets Charlie Strong and the pressure and the blitz, and you know what he's putting together with extra time to prepare. Watch in particular Austin Davis and his ability to run could be the X factor in that game.
Slocum in a tailback here for Fresno State. Fly sweep. Saunders has the corner, has room. Saunders wrestled out of bounds near the 35. Tommy Davis makes the stop.
And I think we're going to see more of this, Coach. They're realizing between the hashes, and I get it, you want to run to set up the play action, but you got to get the speed. The playmakers like Saunders outside, be it through screens, be it through bubble screens, you've got to find a way to get this football on the perimeter.
And that was an arm tackle away from going all the way. So they're going to come back to that play because that had a chance to score.
Rouse popped as he reaches the line of scrimmage. Tyrone Clark lays the lick on Robbie Rouse.
So I'll ask you as a play caller, you did it for many years, Mike. You want to come into this game and run the ball. You want to run it to slow them down instead of play action pass. But when is the point in the game to say, okay, that's not working, enough's enough, let's start spreading this thing out?
Well, this is probably the point. Down 16 in the third quarter, down 16 in the second half. You've got to throw play action off the running looks. You've got to throw the open receivers in the flat right now. You throw to set up the run.
First out of the Wildcat. Makes the first defender miss, but he is dragged down again for a minimal gain. Sean Progar, a guy who was supposed to go to Michigan, then there was the coaching change between Lloyd Carr to Rich Rodriguez, so he was left without a scholarship, had to walk on officially at Northern Illinois. The Huskies gave him a scholarship as soon as it was available. Now a sophomore playmaking defensive end for Northern Illinois.
Probably their best pure pass rusher and the most explosive defensive lineman they have.
And a guy that Coach Dorner, I know, is watching. Remember, he commented on some of these guys that he has as a redshirt sophomore. He's going to get to use him for the next 2 years.
On third down, Colburn completes. It's another third down conversion in the passing game for Fresno State. Isaiah Burse makes the catch. Takes a big hit from Chris Smith, the tough tackling corner for the Huskies.
He is a tough guy, and that's why, you know, he was our impact player today. A lot of these corners, they can cover, and he is their best cover guy. But look at the willingness to come in and tackle. And a lot like Isaiah Burse, maybe the cast isn't quite as big, but you can see the soft cast on his hand as well, playing through a broken hand.
Smith checks out of the game for first down from exactly the 50. Coleman pressured. There's the screen. And it's complete to Michael Harris, picking up about 8. We've been waiting for the screen to show up at some point for the Bulldogs.
Well, they've been very good at it this season. It's been a part of their game plan, and Pat Hill's had success. He's got a big, active offensive line, and when you're playing a front, Mike, that's as active as Northern Illinois is, isn't that a way to slow it down?
No question. And again, you just got to get some plays going where you get a chance to get one of your backs out in space with the blockers ahead of him, whether it's inside or outside. The screen way is the best way internally to get that done.
Colburn from under center out of the eye, handing off to Robbie Rouse. Makes the Husky defenders miss, and now Rouse spins down to the 22.
Again, a little bit of using their own medicine against them, using the draw play, whether it's quarterback draw or tailback draw. And that's the first time Rouse has got a chance to show you what he can do in the open field. Great setup, nice blocking there to allow it to happen. They make some move, puts a foot in the ground, but does it right there. And again, got the club. The club's bigger than the ball right there, it looks like to me, but gets the ball down the field.
And you love those running backs that never slow down when they make a move.
Yep. Keep the speed up. Again, don't stop. Those are guys that go all the way.
Longest run of the day for Robbie Rouse. He nearly doubles his rushing total on that play. He had 23 prior to the 21-yard run. Give it to him again. Rouse tries the stiff arm club.
The stiff club arm.
The stiff club arm. But when you've the got, ball, Jefferson makes a stop.
Yeah, when you've got five Huskies bearing down on you, I felt in that first half, Fresno State, 17 rushes, 25 yards. The game was played the way Northern Illinois wanted it. They wanted to throw a blanket. They wanted to suffocate the line of scrimmage and say, okay, Ryan Colburn, beat us with your arm. Okay, Fresno State receivers, beat us in space. You're really playing into their hands when you're continuing to run between the tackles. And even in that case, with eight guys around the line of scrimmage, you try to run a toss to get outside of it. There's just simply too many guys. You can't get a helmet on a helmet.
Fresno State needs to get in the end zone, trailing by 16. Play clock winding down. Here's the sweep again. Saunders again. Saunders cuts it back inside the 15. Move the chains. It'll be first and 10 from just outside the 10 for the Bulldogs.
What they're doing right now is running to the edge, running away from that 8th and 9th defender in the boxes is on the weak side. They're getting a hat on a hat. Brock, what you talked about on the outside, the receivers are doing a great job blocking the DBs for the Huskies.
And we saw it on the first drive. The very first drive, the most success Fresno State had was what? It was on the perimeter. It was their speed advantage, speed like Burse and Saunders. Keep getting those guys in the open field.
Out of the eye on first and 10. Rouse cuts right inside the 10. Tackled by Jake Kaufman. And a nice sportsmanship move there from the former Marine, Jake Kaufman. Although I understand you are never a former Marine, always a Marine. The pat on the back of the helmet there for Robbie Rouse after he makes the stop.
And more than likely his last game. At 6'5", 250, a bit undersized, doesn't run well enough. He even said, I'm probably going to go serve my country in some capacity again. And what a way to go out.
But you like a motor like that on your team, regardless of where it is.
Reminds me of the relentlessness of Chris Spielman, doesn't it? Just playing sideline to sideline.
Harris in for the Wildcat. Harris stops short, bring up third down.
By the way, I'm going to guess this is four down territory. They can get a first down, but they've got to get a touchdown here. Down 16, in my opinion, more than halfway through the third quarter. I think this is four down territory.
Fresno State has doubled their rushing yards of the first half on this drive.
How much of that depends on this play, Coach? If you're looking at fourth and one or two, because they can still get a first down versus an incomplete here, and you're looking at fourth and five.
Well, 13 points if you kick a field goal. It's a two-possession ball game, whereas a touchdown makes it a one-possession ball game. I'm thinking they're going to go for it.
Colvin on third down, pressured, he fumbles the football. Northern Illinois appears to recover. A red zone turnover for a Fresno State team, making them minus 11 on the year in the turnover margin. Butler forces the strip.
The four down territory question becomes academic, obviously. And this is what I talked about. When you go up through the pocket, you know, as a quarterback, you got to protect that ball. You got to feel the pressure from the side. Peripheral vision didn't happen that time.
Not big enough.
This one.
Still not big enough.
Well, it's the biggest one here.
Let's be honest. No one ever wished for a smaller holiday gift. It's the Lexus December to Remember sales event. And for a limited time, we're celebrating some of our greatest offers of the year. See your Lexus dealer.
Everybody knows you should save for retirement. But what happens when you're about to retire?
How do you go from saving to spending? Fidelity helped us get to this point, and now we're talking about what comes next.
We work together to create a plan to help our money last.
So we can have the kind of retirement we want.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know how this works. Just stay in the line.
Oh, yeah.
Fidelity Investments. Turn here.
Say hello to the new Dremel Trio, the first tool of its kind designed to cut, sand, and route, making it perfect for all kinds of jobs. The handle of the Dremel Trio pivots 90 degrees, giving you the comfort and control to work anywhere, from the floor, to the wall, to the ceiling. With the Dremel Trio's spiral cutting bits, just plunge and cut. Its 360-degree technology allows you to make smooth, intricate cuts in a variety of different materials. With a quick change of accessories, it's perfect for sanding straight or curved edges, from gentle arcs to tight bends. With multiple router bits available, it's an ideal tool for getting into routing for the first time. Check out the Dremel Trio and its ever-growing range of accessories and attachments wherever power tools are sold. Or visit Dremel.com for a free Dremel Projects DVD. Cut, sand, route with the Dremel Trio.
ESPN College Football, the You Drove Humanitarian Bowl, is brought to you by the Lexus December to Remember sales event, now for a limited time at your Lexus dealer, and Fidelity Investments. Turn here.
Conjunction with the 2010 You Drove Humanitarian Bowl, Rockin' Bowl, and then tubing down the slopes. Mike, former offensive coordinator and head coach in football, but how about the bowling form that we saw there from Northern Illinois? I understand you lend some coaching ability in bowling as well, as Harnish completes that pass for a gain of nine.
When you're an assistant coach at a state university, you teach a lot of activity classes. The style was not great, but the pin action was awesome on that, and that's what you teach. If you can't hit that head pin, you better have great pin action.
So you went from splitting the 7-10 to splitting your backs.
That's exactly right, split back attack.
Did you ever coach the tubing down the slopes or the sledding that we saw?
I didn't, because it never snowed very much at Cal State Hayward, but the reality was those kids had a great time, and I couldn't coach him up on that anyway.
And Brian Coffer's getting ready to make you an analyst on Winter X.
I
Layot goes in motion, blocking for Chad Spann. Biggest hole for him to run through today to the 35 as the Huskies pick up another first down. Lauren Bell finally makes the stop, but he is slow getting up off the blue turf.
And again, Spann, tough to stop. And when he gets going, the emotion that he brings, much like Rouse for the Fresno State Bulldogs, it really livens up that entire team. And they'd like to do nothing more here than run the ball down the field, take time off the clock with a 16-point lead.
And while the Fresno State trainers tend to Lauren Bell, we step away.
Drivers, let UDrove take the pain and chaos out of your record keeping and eliminate that paperwork mess. Using your smartphone, driver logs, inspection reports, proofs of delivery, and other paperwork headaches become a thing of the past. UDrove makes managing your business a breeze. To be competitive in the trucking industry, drivers and fleets are turning to UDrove. UDrove, we'll do the rest.
Let's be honest. No one ever wished for a smaller holiday gift. It's the Lexus December to Remember sales event. And for a limited time, we're celebrating some of our greatest offers of the year. See your Lexus dealer.
Here's to America's real working hands. They keep our country going strong with Irwin Vice Grip Tools, like our groove lock pliers that adjust with the press of a button and never slip or pinch. Irwin Vice Grip, reach for greatness.
It's Red Lobster's ultimate surf and turf event with three seafood and steak combinations all under $20, like succulent lobster and wood-grilled sirloin or new Chardonnay shrimp and sirloin. End soon at Red Lobster.
Meet me by the sea again, past the point of shoreline bends, where the sand is soft and warm.
Let's be honest. No one ever wished for a smaller holiday gift. It's the Lexus December to Remember sales event. And for a limited time, we're celebrating some of our greatest offers of the year. See your Lexus dealer.
Time for the Christmas Day NBA World Tiny Player Championships. LeBron. Alley-oop to Wade. Yeah! Dwight Howard. Fight the powered. Ding dong! Kobe going one-on-one with Pierce. Dishes to Lamar Odom. Now you're wide open. Shoot it!
Dude, you're dreaming.
Don't argue. Just shoot it!
Wake up.
Oh, wait. You mean I'm literally dreaming?
Watch the NBA on ABC Christmas Day and see Gulliver's Travels in theaters Christmas Day.
ESPN Monday Night Football. Bears Vikings at 8:30.
Northern Illinois has a terrific running back tradition. LaShawn Johnson led the nation in 1993 in rushing. Michael Turner, a two-time All-American. Garrett Wolf having a great NFL career as well, over 5,000 rushing yards. And now Chad Spann, a former walk-on, who is 20th in the nation, 99 rushing yards a game. He has 20 rushing touchdowns on the season, a Northern Illinois record. That is one less than the national leader, LaMichael James of the Oregon Ducks.
He's not a bad player, huh, Mike?
He's not a bad player. He's got some quicks. He gets work cut out for him against Auburn and Cam Newton.
Harness, what grab by Martell Moore. I want to get your guys' thoughts on Auburn at Oregon in that national championship game, but first, Martell Moore making another terrific catch.
Well, that's a number of times we've seen Martell today go up and make the play with his hands, and what a critical talent to have. Not be a body catcher. When you're a body catcher, you limit your playmaking and your explosiveness. You go up and pluck the ball out of the air like that, and you stand out as a receiver.
And only a sophomore. Another guy, Coach Doran, is going, I like that young man.
Play action on first down. Harnish looking long, incomplete, intended for the fullback, score.
And remember, Scarb had the touchdown earlier in the game. They go unbalanced, showing his flexibility. He's not a runner, but he's a guy that can obviously get down the field. And they like that matchup. They're trying to take advantage of these safeties and linebackers in space.
Actually had a couple of guys open. Landon Cox was open coming across the field. So he had his choice of receivers in that situation. The play action helped that a bunch.
Coach Matukiewicz staying aggressive, not just running the ball and getting conservative, continuing to take shots.
On a complete on the outside, it's Landon Cox who hauls it in across the 50. Are you surprised that we are nearing the end of the third quarter and this is a 16-point game?
No, I'm not. I said this because when we went through the interviews with the coaches, I thought the NIU staff was so excited about being here and felt that they had got the players feeling the same way. I said that energy coming into a bowl game is tough to match for a team like Fresno State that's been here before but may not be as excited to play a non-AQ team.
And remember, Northern Illinois wants to do something they've never done in the history of their program, and that's win 11 games.
Third down, Harness to the air again, complete, first down again. It's Willie Clark, the Huskies' leading receiver, who's dragged down inside the 20 by Lauren Bell.
In emotion and attitude and all of those things are important, but ultimately on this field, it's execution. In the passing game and the balance and the run pass, it's been too much for Fresno State defensively to handle.
Nice job by Willie Clark to find the hole in the zone there and sit in it. And don't run through it. Don't run to be covered, but sit down in the open area. Same play they scored on early. Just a little high on the overthrow. Same motion, end over situation. Again, we'll maybe take a look here and see, but the exact same play they scored on at the end of the half. You see the motion here, 34 coming across. No receiver on that side, and he's bending back. And again, now the safety's there a little bit, but still beaten on the play.
And one of the few misses since early in the game for Harnish. If he's accurate on that throw, it's another touchdown for Northern Illinois.
Spann gets it on second down. Spann cuts it back. Touchdown Huskies in Chad Spann. 21st rushing touchdown of the season for the senior from Indianapolis.
That may be the nail in the coffin. Fresno State has been outscored in the second and fourth quarters. They're going to have to change that if they expect to get back in this ball game tonight.
What great push there on the edge, and a lot like Fresno State's playmakers, you give Spann just a little bit of space, and he's going to make you pay. Just too much balance, too much innovation. They've out-schemed them, they've outplayed them, they've out-hustled them, and Northern Illinois right now in complete control.
Chad Spann, the former walk-on player, said, "Never doubted my ability." He came to Northern Illinois as a walk-on. 2 weeks into his Husky career, he had a scholarship. Says, "I'm going to answer the football phone if it rings, but if not, I'm going to go back to hometown, Indianapolis, and be a coach and a teacher." Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN Wednesday night. The Utah Utes take on Kellenmore and the Boise State Broncos, who usually call this stadium home. The Mako Bowl, Las Vegas, Wednesday, 8 Eastern, also available online and on your phone.
Kellenmore, I believe, is the best quarterback in the nation. I would have voted for him. I think Cam Newton is the best football player. But Kellenmore, with his, he's not the tallest guy, not the fast guy, not the strongest arm, but he throws people open. He's got great vision and decision.
Now, you would have voted him what?
Best quarterback. David O'Brien Award.
Perfect.
Yes.
Not okay. Heisman Trophy.
No, not Heisman.
Clearly
no.
Won one.
What about Andrew Luck?
I still think Andrew Luck is a great football player and a bigger physical specimen, but what Kellenmore has accomplished, not just this year, but over his entire career, he is just so good and so cerebral.
Chad Spann and his guys right now in complete control, and if you're Fresno State, you must start making the explosive play.
Lomovsky.
Got a chance for a return here now.
Instead, Burse is wrestled down near the 27.
But you're right. Right now, Fresno State has to take some chances. They've got to rip and strip on defense, get some turnovers. They've got to score fairly quickly.
0-5 versus the non-automatic qualifying teams. That's basically the teams who aren't from the six conferences who have automatic qualifying bids into the BCS Bowls, such as Northern Illinois out of the MAC. Fresno State really hangs its hat on the anyone, anywhere, anytime, going to play the big programs, beating the big programs. They won 7 of their last 10 against the automatic qualifying BCS schools. As Colburn scrambles away from pressure, heaves it downfield. It's caught. Raphael, the fullback, bailing out his quarterback. Colburn finally wrestled down at the 45.
And remember, the Fresno State is 2-0 in bowl games on this blue turf, so let's not rule them out yet.
And if I'm Fresno State, it's got to go up tempo, doesn't it, Coach? You're down 23, nearing the fourth quarter. This is not rush. It doesn't have to be full on, no huddle, but it better be your 2-minute drill to get as many plays as possible to try to chip away at this deficit.
You're absolutely right. They're three full scores down, three possessions. They're going to get that, but they've got to make them all count.
Wildcat here. It's Michael Harris takes the direct snap, fly sweep. Saunders drilled as he reaches the 45. Fresno State the last 2 years outscored in the fourth quarter in their bowl games 34-10, and losses to Colorado State and Wyoming, both of those games the New Mexico Bowl. If they're going to come back and win the 2010 Udrove Humanitarian Bowl, they're going to have to flip that script and have a big comeback in the fourth.
Well, one challenge for Coach Doran next year is he's going to lose a lot of veteran leadership. And if one thing has emerged, the Jake Kaufmans of the world on this team, the Chad Spans, the leadership. Now, Coach told us and said, hey, it's not the coaches that have had the success this season. It's been the leadership. Seven seniors defensively, really led by that guy. And they're leader. And how about Coach Matukowicz tonight? He's got to love the effort of his Huskies.
Christmas Day, Bulls Knicks on ESPN, then Celtics Magic and Heat Lakers on ABC.
Are you a mobile professional who wants to eliminate the hassle of tracking expenses and mileage? With Udrove Professional, you can. Using the GPS and camera capabilities of your smartphone, Udrove automates the management of your receipts and mileage log. End of the month expense reports become a thing of the past, as Udrove captures this information in real time. Save time and be more productive with Udrove Professional. Udrove, we'll do the rest.
Let's be honest. No one ever wished for a smaller holiday gift. It's the Lexus December to Remember sales event, and for a limited time, we're celebrating some of our greatest offers of the year. See your Lexus dealer.
Good for 23 yards.
Hey, you went to Jared.
That's a peerless diamond, the ideal cut diamond. What?
If you want to create your own one-of-a-kind ring, get to Jared this Friday through Sunday, because you can receive Get Set and Diamonds rewards up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds and hundreds of settings. Get up to a $1,000 reward this Friday through Sunday at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
A million miles matters, and to prove it, we've given Karen an ordinary GPS and Phil a TomTom GPS with a million more miles of road. Do drivers prefer more miles? We're about to find out.
Not again.
With all the success that Adrian was having, it was getting tough to juggle his schedule, so we got him an assistant.
If I can get you to sign that, that'd be great. And oh, by the way, for Mom's birthday?
Perfect.
We had to get someone who could anticipate his every need.
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
Which one? Write me.
Done. Oh, your 3 p.m. is waiting.
When you hit that next level, man, there aren't enough hours in the day.
He'll be with you when he's with you.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
You are going to be a very important sorcerer. But for now, you're my apprentice.
Sock. Let's go train.
Oh!
And again.
This is crazy.
But it is fun.
The Sorcerer's Apprentice.
Movie start at channel 125.
The road to the most college basketball begins with ESPN Full Court on DirecTV. Watch top-ranked teams from across the nation collide, no matter where you live. Get over 30 games per week of key rivalries and top conference action you can't see anywhere else. Every game is a home game with ESPN Full Court on DirecTV.
Don't miss your chance to get a piece of the action. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit directtv.com/fullcourt.
Prior to the fourth quarter, Sean Hubbard recognized as the Truckload Carriers Association Angel of the Year. Hubbard saved the life of Armando Duenas, a motorist who was trapped inside a burning car on November 13th, 2009. So, a very nice presentation there for Sean Hubbard as the Highway Angel of the Year. Fourth quarter of the Udrow Humanitarian Bowl from Boise, Idaho. Carter Blackburn with Brock Hewitt, Mike Bellotti, and Shelly Smith. The 23-point lead for Northern Illinois. Either the Huskies are going to win a school record 11th straight game, or we're going to have a tremendous comeback in bowl game number two of the year.
Certainly Fresno would prefer the latter. They get a start, though. Again, you get an average of about 67 possessions per half. So figuring that out, they might get three possessions this quarter. They have to cash in on each one of them.
Including right here. Third and five, screen, Colburn pass, incomplete.
And gosh, that was set up so well. Three blockers out in front, probably would have gone the distance. A little bit too much pressure, couldn't get the ball to the receiver.
And you love to dial blitz up. We've talked about it tonight for 45 minutes. You love that blitz against all the pressure. And you're exactly right. Two linemen out there, just one defender for Northern Illinois. That was the right call, just a lack of execution.
Have to go for it here, don't you?
Absolutely.
And the Bulldogs do.
The interesting thing here will be whether or not NIU comes with pressure. They want to get the ball out of the hand quickly, I would assume.
Colburn to throw on fourth down. It is patted away, incomplete, intended for Evans. Chris Smith knocks it away from Rashad Evans.
Again, that was no pressure. That was just a four-man rush, but great play by the corner showing that anticipation.
And those corners, the eyes in with the quarterback. He sees the quick drop. We saw Smith earlier in the game on a quick drop with a little hitch route, make a play. The difference tonight, Northern Illinois, more plays on the field.
To rephrase the question.
I'm not going to be the person I'm expected to be anymore.
Be unexpected. Bleu de Chanel.
At Macy's.
Oh, and I need to sign these paychecks.
Sure.
Man, I've never seen this place so busy.
Yeah, we washed like 30 labradoodles this week, and there's a cat show in town. Sorry, hairball.
Wouldn't it be great to have a back office for your small business? With Intuit Payroll, you do. Now you can make payday effortless and keep the taxes straight. We do the legwork so you can do what you love. Intuit, small business, rejoice.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake, you will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Taco Bell's $2 meal deal, each with a Taco Bell original, Doritos chips, and a medium soda. Three items, $2. Now that's a deal.
So I buy a beefy five-layer burrito and drink, and you throw in the chips for free?
How about you just give me $2, and it's all free?
Let's do it. Why pay more?
Northern Illinois is just 14 minutes and 10 seconds away from a school record 11th win They had a 9-game winning streak snapped in the MAC championship when Miami came back to beat the Huskies. Harness rolling on first down, heaving to the sideline. That's a catch, and a great catch by Ashford.
Showed great range and length to roll this in. Again, you see him right here. Does he get his foot down? Does he keep that, tap that toe? Looks like he does. That's all you need. It may be reviewed, but it's a great catch in my mind.
You know what I'm seeing tonight? A really well-coached team.
It, preparation and execution. I think sometimes you have preparation, you don't always execute, but I agree with you. I think they look very well coached.
And here comes the review.
The previous play is under further review.
Well, we mentioned that Jerry Kill, head coach, taking the Minnesota job. Both coordinators go with them, but offensive coordinator for the day, Robert Reeves, defensive coordinator, Jay Solvell, and acting head coach, Tom Matukowicz, have all been together for over a decade as coaches, going back to Emporia State and then Southern Illinois with Jerry Kill and now Northern Illinois. So this is not a coaching staff that hasn't been through reps before. And we talked, this is a team that won 9 straight games. They were ranked 25th in the country. Had they won that MAC, well, they would have been the hottest team, one of the hottest teams in the country going into bowl game.
Well, and it was a 4th-and-20, Carter. We saw that. We were in Fresno watching that
crazy
game.
Play.
Yeah, and it was a 4th-and-20 on a tip pass and then a blown assignment to lose it. You're right. They convert that 4th-and-20. You're looking at BCS-wise probably the 23rd ranked team in America.
And they're hoping to crack that top 25 final ranking. But Brock, you made the point too. The coaches have talked about the fact that even though some coaches are gone, the same players we got here with are with us right now. You guys make the plays. You do it out there on the field. And when a coach will say that about his players, the players will play like heck for him.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
Do you think Coach Matukowicz wants a lot of replays here in the fourth quarter?
I think he wants. He may call timeouts when he just to keep it going, as he said.
What he told Shelley walking off, take the timeouts to keep this going as long as he could. He will stay as an assistant coach to Dave Doran at Northern Illinois. A lot of decisions in the coming days for the current Northern Illinois coaching staff. Harnish. We'll take a sack on first down. Yeah, this is one of the great quotes of the bowl season from Tom Matukowicz talking to Shelly Smith just before halftime.
Hey, I'll tell you what, the other thing about those straight timeouts, if I can make this thing last longer, I'm going to do it now. I don't know if I'll ever get my opportunity, but I'm having a good time.
So he may be the first coach in America to ask for replays, even on completions. I don't know, guys. You may want to take another look at that one. He's having so much fun, and you're right. When it's genuine, players respond to that.
He's a native of Silver Lake, Kansas. The incoming Northern Illinois head coach, Dave Doran, is a Kansas native as well. Fly sweep is going to go for a solid gain for the Huskies of Northern Illinois.
Again, both staffs borrowing from each other in terms of halftime adjustments, seeing the fly sweep now from NIU. And again, what Fresno State had success with in the first half.
Jasmine Hopkins on the sweep.
He's a first-year junior college transfer, had nearly 2,000 yards last year at Fort Scott, one of their more explosive playmakers.
And again, for that play to work, your receivers have to have great block, either ability to sustain blocks or get angles and cross block.
You know, the other great thing about coaches and coaching in particular, put your guys in position for success. They have very clear personnel packages to highlight the talent, and that play there with Hopkins showing off his speed.
Span gets it on first and goal and has his second rushing touchdown of the day. Northern Illinois is making a statement on the blue turf in Boise.
Span runs it in from the end yard line.
You think Chad Span wants to end his career the right way? Do you think Jake Kaufman wants to end his career the right way? Do you think Pat Hill's going to turn that hat around, coach, as you said, and put the rally cap on?
He's going to need to do it pretty soon, I'll tell you what.
Talk about how Chad Spann walked on. He grew up with Darren Evans, now at Virginia Tech, and said, I know they competed against each other, good friends. Said, I know Darren Evans can do it at Virginia Tech. I can do it on the Division I level, no matter the lack of scholarship offers and the lack of size. And he has 22 rushing touchdowns on the year, more than anyone in the nation.
Hey. Drivers, let UDrove take the pain and chaos out of your record keeping and eliminate that paperwork mess. Using your smartphone, driver logs, inspection reports, proofs of delivery, and other paperwork headaches become a thing of the past. UDrove makes managing your business a breeze. To be competitive in the trucking industry, drivers and fleets are turning to UDrove. UDrove, we'll do the rest.
With the Capital One Venture Card, we get double miles on every purchase. So we earned a holiday trip to the Big Apple twice as fast.
Dinner!
We get double miles every time we use our card. And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang. It's hard to beat double miles.
I want a mace, a sword, ow!
Get the Venture Card from Capital One and earn double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
I wonder what it can be.
What's in your wallet?
Rated M for mature. There's only one vehicle tough enough to play in this world. The 2011 Jeep Wrangler Call of Duty Black Ops Edition. With a redesigned interior, the new Jeep Wrangler remains one tough 4x4.
People choose 5-Hour Energy over 7 million times a week for lots of reasons. It's a nutritional supplement that really works. Its key ingredients can also be found in everyday foods like avocado, broccoli, bananas, or already in you. It contains about as much caffeine as a cup of the leading premium coffee, zero sugar, 4 calories. What's going to be your reason for choosing 5-Hour Energy? Its effectiveness? Its beneficial ingredients? There's only one way to know. Try it today.
ESPN College Football, the UDrove Humanitarian Bowl, is brought to you by your friends at UDrove and the Capital One Venture Card. What's in your wallet?
Dylan Hargreaves, Sam Rogers, Teddy Culbertson, entertaining the fans outside of Broncos Stadium here. They'll all be competing in the Winter X Games, January 28th through the 31st on ESPN from Aspen, Colorado.
And just full disclosure, since we've been together all year, Mike and I were really pulling for you to get on there and try one of those, Carter.
Well, I did. They just didn't, got cut. It's on the editing room floor. Couldn't fit in the Elvis machine.
I was going to want you to wear a big helmet that went bubbles on both hands.
I was going to wear that boing, boing, boing Santa hat that we saw earlier, Mike. Burris picks it up on the bounce to the 28. Let's check in with Chris Fowler.
All right, Carter, thanks. After your game, it's off to New Orleans. Jarrell Jernigan of Troy has scored touchdowns 5 different ways this season. They'll take on an Ohio team trying to build on the MAC momentum of Illinois. North versus South. Arnold Carrier's New Orleans Bowl coming up next. Guys.
Chris, MAC momentum in bowl games has been rare. The MAC has lost 14 of its last 15 bowl games. Central Michigan snapped a 14-game losing streak by the Gomez. Double OT game, the GMAC Bowl in Mobile against Troy. And we're going to be in Mobile at the end of this bowl season for the GoDaddy of them all. The GoDaddy.com Bowl. Should I trademark that now in case it goes on for 125 years? This is a big win for Northern Illinois and the MAC. I mean, it's a conference that's lost 3 head coaches, including Jerry Kill, during the last couple of weeks. But a 30-point edge. It could be back-to-back MAC bowl wins.
No, you're right. It's a state. And Fresno State is a national team. Your win is not against the Sun Belt team. And heck, there's still 12 minutes to go in this one. But this really would, for the MAC conference that has struggled so mightily in these situations, to have the dominating effort we've seen tonight.
Another MAC team. Ohio will be looking for its first bowl win ever against Troy in the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl coming up next.
And Pat Hill's a great coach. Don't let what happens here tonight affect that decision, because he's gotten 8 or 9 wins every single year, and he plays the best teams in the country anywhere, anytime.
11 bowls in 12 years for Fresno State. Evans wrestled down by Tyrone Clark.
Oh, and Pat Hill was very honest with us yesterday. And many of these losses to the non-automatic qualifying schools have been against very good teams, an Air Force team, a Tulsa team. And he ranked this one. He knew coming into this it would be a heck of a dogfight. Watching the level of detail, the preparation, the talent, the speed, he felt like this Northern Illinois team was going to be a very difficult matchup for him.
Well, and he's running to a buzzsaw tonight. I mean, this is a great football team that lost a game they probably shouldn't have lost in the championship, and obviously came out tonight with a vengeance.
On fourth down, Morales across the first down marker. That'll move the chains.
Still surprised, though, that Fresno's not going no huddle. I guess they've decided that their best deal is to huddle up each time and get the best play in and get the substitution groups right.
To me, this has almost been less about Fresno State. They have the one mistake, but much more about Northern Illinois, really on both sides of the ball.
Colbert screen. Ellis, or rather Harris, gets it on first down, and the screen produces a first down for Fresno State. Tuesday night, Capital One Bowl week continues. Southern Miss versus Louisville and the Beeple Brady's Bowl, St. Petersburg, Tuesday, 8 Eastern. Larry Fedora, head coach at Southern Miss. Charlie Strong, head coach at Louisville. They used to be on the staff together at Florida on the opposite sides of the football. And not surprisingly, Larry Fedora's Southern Miss team, excellent offense. Charlie Strong's Louisville team, excellent defense.
Louisville used to be known for the high scoring, but they're the 15th rated defense in the nation right now. It'd be interesting to see whether defense trumps offense in that situation.
And what a credit to Charlie Strong, year one.
Pressure coming. Colburn evades it, but not for long. Jefferson ends up with the sack. The bold Jefferson, the sophomore from Chicago, has been making plays in the middle of the Northern Illinois defense today.
Combination of pressure and tight man coverage. No free safety. That was zero coverage. Everybody well handled down the field.
Fresno State taking a lot of time.
Hey, a little surprised by that. What is that saying?
Well, the reality is it's saying that we're not trying to win. We just don't want to lose by as much. And I'm surprised a little bit because a Pat Hill team never gives up.
Long drop for Colburn. Screen again, complete again. Harris has it again. And another first down for Fresno State. Harris cuts back, stays in bounds all the way down to the 28.
And Fresno's come back to that weak side screen repeatedly. Now they figured out at halftime that NIU was coming off that weak side edge with four. There's only one defender left over there. They've hit this play. It should have been a touchdown earlier. Got a big play right there. They'll keep coming back to this as long as the Huskies want to blitz.
How about the day for Ryan Colburn? 22 of 29 for 247. We haven't seen the deep ball, the big play like we saw when Fresno State hit the 78-yarder.
Yeah, like
against Illinois Saunders.
Right, Carl, to the point earlier, I mean, usually you see a 40 to 10 game like this, and it's because one team has just fallen all over themselves. They've turned it over and had negative play after negative play. That's not been the case. Northern Illinois has just had an answer in every phase of the game tonight.
Flag coming, apparently against Chris Smith and the coverage on A.J. Johnson.
Okay, now you said this earlier. Come back to the screen. This is about the fourth time we've seen Chris Smith.
Pass interference. Defense, number five. Penalty enforced and spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Very aggressive on these quick passes. When does the double move come?
Well, you're right. Here he had a safety over the top helped him so he could stand to be aggressive. When that safety is not there, I expect to see the double move route anytime against Chris, because you're right. The more aggressive he gets, the more likely they are to run a hitch and go or something like that to take advantage of the aggression he's showing.
And that's a real credit. That's, again, a teaching, coaching point. Knowing he has a safety over the top, still baiting the fifth-year senior to throw it, not giving that coverage away too early.
Wildcat, Burris takes it on first down. Only a couple of yards for Isaiah Burris off the Wildcat.
Well, Well, I tell you what, I think the biggest thing is they've got to get a touchdown here, and they're not going to settle for a field goal. They may surprise me, but the reality is they got to get in the end zone.
Colbert swings it. Incomplete. Off of Isaiah Burse's hands.
And I just love it. Sticking to the mentality. I don't care what the score is. It's 40-10. I have my plan of action, and Coach Matukiewicz continuing to stick to that to be very aggressive. I have a question for you, Mike. Yesterday, in meeting with Coach, he talked about putting a bowl council, an advisory group together with players. Had you heard of that through from a coaching staff before?
Yes. In fact, a lot of teams will have some type of representation from the players, but that's the first thing he did when he became the head coach, was named it. He said, I'm going to have a council. I'm going to have an athlete from each position representing, and they're going to help us decide on schedule, on curfew, how much they practice, that type of thing. So the players were involved with it. I think that was a smart idea. I think that certainly shows that he's thinking of the players and wants their input.
Colbert evades the sack and picks up a couple positive yards. Fourth down coming. Coach Matukiewicz said he spoke with a few different coaches from around the country, including Bill Stewart, the head coach at West Virginia, who took over a team as an interim head coach in a similar situation. Stewart was then named the head coach, and now there's going to be another head coach at West Virginia in a couple of years.
After the play was over, personal foul, defense, number 20. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
I have heard people say that the West Virginia situation is similar to the one at Oregon, but it's not.
It's not, as I understand it, because there's a timeline set. I believe Bill Stewart will coach one more year, and then the new, it's not a coach in waiting. Dana Holverson is becoming the offensive coordinator, so he'll learn the team, get to know them, and then he'll assume the head coaching job the following year.
Instead of a fourth down try here for Fresno State, first and goal from inside the 10. Bulldogs need to get in the end zone to have any shot, down by 30 points in the fourth.
Continuing the blitz, just like you talked about, Brock, and it's getting to the quarterback.
Butler is the man who blitzed and brought pressure, and then Sean Progar finishes it off. The sixth sack of the day from Northern Illinois. Turnabout on a Fresno State team that prides itself on getting to the QB.
Yeah, and you've got to have an answer down there, whether it was a hot receiver or just getting rid of the ball. You can't take a sack when you've just got a penalty to put you down there inside.
30-point game. Bulldogs need a score.
Join Boomer and the gang for Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Good for 23 yards.
Hey, you went to Jared.
That's a peerless diamond, the ideal cut diamond. What?
If you want to create your own one-of-a-kind ring, get to Jared this Friday through Sunday, because you can receive Get Set and Diamonds rewards up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds and hundreds of settings. Get up to a $1,000 reward this Friday through Sunday at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Stay frosty.
Nice.
Grizzlies!
Watch out, watch out!
Hey, honey.
Goodfellas, Dangerous Hunts 2011, rated T for teen. For all that's out there, Range Rover Sport, powered by intelligence.
Right now, when you buy one juicy original chicken sandwich at Burger King, you get a second one for free. It's more than a handful, it's a handsful. Buy one, get one free, only at Burger King.
Here's to America's real working hands. They keep our country going strong with Irwin Vice Grip Tools, like our groove lock pliers that adjust with the press of a button and never slip or pinch. Irwin Vice Grip, reach for greatness.
That's out there. Range Rover Sport, powered by intelligence.
Great tradition of Capital One Bowl Week. Both teams, Northern Illinois and Fresno State in the Boise area, visiting local hospitals, the St. Luke's Medical Center, Pediatric Floor, and the Veterans Hospital here in Boise, Idaho. That's a great shot there of Chandler Harness, the quarterback for Northern Illinois. He has a future in politics, I believe.
You know, it's great for the people they visit, but I'll tell you what, the players get a lot out of that, too. It makes them feel so good and appreciate their own health and welfare.
Colburn's pass caught by A.J. Ellis. It'll be for a loss as the Huskies continue to fly to the football. That's Chris Smith again breaking up a play in the Fresno State backfield.
Well, he was ready for that when he beat the block to stop that screen before it got started.
What did the coaches say about him? He went from suspect to prospect.
Yeah.
As far as the NFL was concerned, they see the quickness, and I'll tell you, he has a real high football IQ and awareness of what's going on.
Colburn heaves it to the end zone, intended for Evans. Flag coming, it's on Chris Smith. Well, Chris, we were just praising you and all of your efforts, and now
you know, I tell you what, I see him as a safety at the next level. That's one of the things. I mean, I'm not sure about his total foot speed to cover, but he's aggressive. He can make tackles.
Defense, number five, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, we've seen how aggressive, and that's exactly what we wanted. Maybe not a double move, but with a guy that you see this active, that's a good call by Jeff Grady. Make sure, get your speed out there. And Rashad Evans, a guy that can run, he has a step and a half. And, you know, frankly, that's a smart play by Chris Smith, knowing your beat, Mike, and forcing the pass interference instead of giving up a touchdown.
Victor E. Husky was not pleased with the penalty flag there on Chris Smith. Victor E. Bulldog agreed with it.
I bet one of them tried to chew it up, actually.
First down from just outside the 10. Colburn goes right back to Rashad Evans for the touchdown.
I think that's going to be a penalty. You see some of the frustration here in the fourth quarter. Some extracurricular activities. I think that's going to be on Evans for throwing the football.
And again, the other question is whether Fresno will try an onside kick to try
after
and
the score,
maintain possession.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, offense number 11. That penalty will be enforced on the ensuing kickoff.
And now when it's a 15-yard penalty on the kickoff, unfortunately, you don't probably onside from your own 15-yard line, because if you don't get it, that's too great a field position.
So Evans gets the touchdown, and then let's see what happens after the play. He tosses it at the cornerback, Patrick George. That's an easy automatic flag, 15-yard penalty. Fresno State in the end zone for the first time since their opening drive. But the Bulldogs still down big, kicking off from their own 15 when they come back.
Today's economy depends on the $660 billion trucking industry, and truck drivers depend on Udrove. Trucks bring life's essentials, from hauling equipment to football games, to bringing snacks and drinks for your tailgate party. To remain competitive, trucking companies are lowering costs and advancing productivity with Udrove. By eliminating paperwork, Udrove is helping to make the trucking industry more efficient. Udrove, we'll do the rest.
Anything you can do, they can do bigger.
I love it when a plan comes together.
The A-Team, go bigger with the extended cut.
It's Red Lobster's ultimate surf and turf event, with three seafood and steak combinations all under $20, like succulent lobster and wood-grilled sirloin, or new Chardonnay shrimp and sirloin. End soon at Red Lobster.
When it comes to investing, no one person has all the answers.
So TD Ameritrade doesn't give me just one person.
Questions about retirement?
I talk to their retirement account specialist.
Bonds? Grab the phone. Fixed income specialist.
TD Ameritrade knows investors sometimes need real live help.
Not just one broker, a whole team there to help.
Help me decide what's right for me.
People with answers at TD Ameritrade.
Get up to $500 when you open an account.
When an industry leader like Sony offers special deals on their high-quality products, they move pretty quickly. So Peyton and I stop by to help out.
Back.
40.
Save more than $800 when you buy a Sony Home Entertainment package with a 3D Blu-ray disc player. Enjoy HD movies, even in 3D. Visit a participating retailer for details.
We're off to a good start. We're sending a lot of product out. Got a lot of work to do. We need a little more production out of you.
I tell you what, the other thing about those three timeouts, if I can make this thing last longer, I'm going to do it now. I don't know if I'll ever get my opportunity, but I'm having a good time.
Well, today is Saturday. Northern Illinois will fly back to DeKalb on Sunday. And then on Monday, Tom Latugewicz is an assistant coach once again. Today, he is the head coach. Said the three goals for this game: win the game, get to that school record 11th win, have fun and celebrate a good season. 5 minutes, 31 seconds away from the Huskies accomplishing all three of those.
And I'll tell you, there's one really happy camper in Madison, Wisconsin. That's new coach Dave Doran. Knowing that he's got that guy on his staff, a genuine guy that you see his team respond to his leadership.
Gessling's kick fielded at the 30. Remember, it's from the 15 because the penalty after the touchdown, giving Tommy Davis a chance to return to the 45, and us to check in with Chris Fowler.
Carter, thank you. Tom Matsukowicz becoming a media sensation tonight. Meanwhile, over on ESPN2, college basketball in Oklahoma City, SEC Big 12, and the Cowboys a 4-point lead over the Crimson Tide. Final 3 minutes of the game. Coming up next, here's a quarterback combination for Ohio University. They'll run the pistol formation against Troy out of the Sun Belt, the Arnold Carriers, New Orleans Bowl, after we get finished in the blue rug. Back to you guys.
Media sensation Tom Matsukowicz and the Northern Illinois Huskies now 5:23 away from making it back-to-back wins for MAC teams in bowl games after that thrilling win last year, the GMAC Bowl, and now Ohio's going to take on Troy next. Is that pass complete to the 30? The frozen tundra of TCF Bank Stadium in Minnesota will host ESPN's Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. Bears versus Vikings coverage begins 7 Eastern with Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's. No Brett Favre in the lineup for the Vikings.
Adrian Peterson can run in any conditions, any field, anywhere.
And Jay Cutler better hope it's not windy. You can play in cold, really. Quarterbacks in snow, even. It's the wind and the cold that just makes it miserable.
Oh, boy. That is going to be a cold Gatorade dump. Mike, prepare us here for what a coach is thinking. Closing minutes now. Tom Matsukowicz, which has never been a head coach at any level, he has not experienced the Gatorade dump.
You know, you're never ready for offense. It because you're just so excited and happy. You hope still that it happens, down. In all honesty.
Oh, come on, guys. He's going to lap it up. Are you kidding me?
That's
he's
true.
Gonna run. He's going to stand underneath it and want to be bathed in Gatorade.
You know, he's got the pedal to the metal still, though. They're throwing the ball in the fourth quarter ahead by how much? 23 points. And again, but he's not going to be head coach any longer, so nobody can accuse him of running up
that's
the
right,
score.
That's right. Let it fly.
Hey, let's go out and have some fun. Let the kids play.
But Tom Matsukowicz did say it's his goal to be a head coach at some point, so it would be looking like a bowl win here in his turn as interim head coach. But one of the reasons he decided to stay with Dave Doran in Northern Illinois, new head coach, rather than moving on, was to be part of another coaching staff. He's been part of Jerry Kill's for 11 years, and that opportunity to get some new exposure to new ideas, meet new people, and hopefully become a head coach down the road.
That's right. In fact, yesterday, you know, quoted as saying, I've learned everything from Coach Gill, and I've taken in all of those teachable moments, and now I'm ready to learn a new plan, a new way to win.
It's expanding your horizons. It's expanding your network and looking at somewhat new ideas on how to do things and how to build a winning plan.
And he was very emphatic as well, saying there are no negatives in this, Jerry Kill moving on after three seasons. Remember, 2007, Northern Illinois was a 2-10 football team. Three straight bowl games. If they can close this out, it'll be a school record 11 wins. So Coach Tucker would say, hey, happy for Jerry Kill, happy for the coaches who are going to be with him in Minnesota, that they have a chance to coach in the Big Ten. They've elevated Northern Illinois' football program, and now it's job of Dave Doran in the next staff. Oh, are they waiting on us? Are they waiting on us with the Gatorade dump? Not yet. Not yet.
They have the players having fun on the sidelines, too, which is good.
Jordan Delligal appears to be leading the charge here. Span wrestled down. That's Ben Jacobs, the outstanding middle linebacker for Fresno State. Haven't called his name a lot tonight, making his 52nd consecutive start every game of his Bulldog career. Our Capital One player of the game is that man, Chandler Harness, the junior from Bluffton, Indiana. 372 total yards, three touchdowns, two rushing, one through the air.
Very deserving. What an unbelievable night tonight in terms of both throwing the football with accuracy and running the ball, being the primary cog in the running attack.
Yeah, he was the difference maker. I'll tell you, a real close second has got to be the ex-Marine, though, does it not? Jake Kaufman on the other side, a Humanitarian Bowl record, three sacks, was relentless in his pursuit all night long. I think a 1 and 1A.
Harness throwing on fourth down to the end zone, incomplete. So Fresno State will get the football with exactly 2 minutes remaining.
Willie Clark,
as we keep a close eye on the Gatorade dump to come. Coming up after the game, ESPN, the 2010 Arnold Carriers New Orleans Bowl, Ohio versus Troy. Then tune into ESPN News for a post-game extra to wrap up our game immediately following this game. Log on to ESPN3.com for live coverage of the Udrof Humanitarian Bowl trophy ceremony. Complete on first down from Colburn to the outside. It's Saunders who makes the catch. Well, guys, how about Northern Illinois in the future? This is going to be the school record 11th win. A new head coach, Dave Doran, coming in. There's an excellent crop of seniors, including Jake Kaufman, who leave the program. This is a team to be reckoned with next season in the MAC, next season in college football.
Well, I can't believe we've played this whole game, and I've not mentioned one time an offensive line that was also really good tonight. And every one of those guys returns. In fact, four of them will be redshirt seniors next season. That's a heck of a group to build around.
Yeah, there's only two seniors on the entire offense, and it's a tailback and a fullback. Everybody else comes back, including Chandler Harness, who I think is the key to everything.
This could be a top 25 team at the beginning of the 2011 season.
Absolutely, no question, they will be left.
Colburn's pass is caught, but a flag is down.
Holding, offense, number 69. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Get ready.
I'm ready. I'm wearing my raincoat up here. Oh, yeah, it's that calm before the storm when somebody's usually talking to you, trying to distract you, while the other guys are backing away. If you get good peripheral vision, you sort of roll your neck to cover up so it doesn't go down the back and down your shorts and into your shoes.
And it hasn't frozen yet, which would be an even more painful dump. And there it is. The immediately enthusiasm that we felt from the Northern Illinois coaching staff, from the Northern Illinois players. Interim head coach Tom Matukowicz gets the Gatorade shower. So does defensive coordinator Jay Solvell.
And I'm going to guess this is probably the most fun day of his life.
Less than a minute to go. That pass is incomplete, stopping the clock at 45. Well, let's go back to the first Gatorade dump of Tom Matukowicz's coaching career. Oh, boy.
That was flush.
When you turn around to look, that's a bad thing, too.
Well, the headset got ripped off.
Well, you can't afford a lot of headsets at that level.
I hear that was an impressive move. The level of detail.
Exactly.
Where does it end with the program?
Well, the three goals were win the game, get that school record 11, celebrate a good season, and have fun. That is clearly checked off all three for the Northern Illinois Huskies.
And they can add celebrate the bowl win, too.
And there will be. How about the last 2 weeks of this football program? You have a chance to win the MAC championship, first time in 27 years. You lose the game in the final minute on a fourth and 20 play.
This is for us. This is for us, man.
And what did he say? The story is already written, guys.
The story is already written.
It's going to go one of two ways. It's either going to be all through this adversity, they folded up their tent and they quit, or it's going to be amidst all of this distraction. They came together and dominated exactly what they did tonight.
Well, Coach Maciejewicz said as soon as that plane door closes and we're on our way to Boise, everything else is behind us. And the future is not going to play into it. We're not going to worry about who's going where, who's not going where, who's going to be the coach here. It's about going to play a bowl game and winning that bowl game.
And they only brought the committed. They made the kids sign up. They had to sign off in the presence of the council guy to say they were all in. They're committed to winning. They didn't care about the rest of it. So they brought guys that were all in.
It's the one thing, Mike, that I think you and I really miss about football. I mean, this is tremendous.
The sense of accomplishment.
The sense of accomplishment in the team. And we have a team and a great team of the director and producer and all our personnel. And we come together and we come in and we come out. The difference in football, these guys live it every day. They get a chance to be a team and to celebrate this moment, not as an individual, but as an entire group, is something so very special.
And the camaraderie that these young men have and this whole team and whole program right now is really fun to watch.
Now, does he take a timeout?
now what does Shelly have in store? What does he have in store for Shelly after this game too? I think it's must watch TV.
He said it's reality TV at its best. Watching this team unfold, watching them come here for this game is reality TV at its best. He's cleaning up the field too.
That is a coach enjoying his time as the head man. A very good Northern Illinois football team takes care of business at the 2010 Udrove Humanitarian Bowl, a school record 11th win. The players hoist interim head coach Tom Maciejewicz onto the field here in Boise.
I miss this right here. I'll tell you, that is at the end of the game, you're going to shake the other guy's hand, going to see the faces in the locker room, the joy on the kids and the players and the coaches' faces. It's amazing.
And here's Shelly Smith.
Okay, how was that Gatorade shower?
It's never felt so finer. I tell you what, that was nice. These kids are amazing. This has been a season of life, and we told our story about a team that's coming together, and I can't be any more happier than this.
What does it mean to this program?
Well, it means, hey, we had a top 25 rankings. All right, we lost that ranking, and now we got a victory against a good football team. I'm telling you right now, we should start next year in the top 25.
All right, great. Thank you so much. All right.
40-17, Northern Illinois gets its school record 11th win of the season, winning the 2010 Udrove Humanitarian Bowl here in Boise. Live coverage of the trophy ceremony on ESPN3.com. For Brock here with Mike Velotti, Shelly Smith, and our entire crew, I'm Carter Blackburn. Now we send you back to the studio.
All right, Carter, Brock, Mike, thank you. Next up, off to New Orleans, Terrence McCray, the top receiver for the Ohio Bobcats of Frank Solich, as they try to continue their late season momentum, 1-7 of 8 coming in. And all of a sudden, the MAC conference feeling some moxie in the bowl season. The guys have talked about the fact they lost 14 in a row till Central Michigan beat Troy last year. But this is not Troy. This is Fresno State, a team that, you know, had 8 wins coming in and a very impressive performance in a night that Tom Maciejewicz will never forget as the interim head coach. That's a beatdown.
It is a thorough beatdown. And you know what, Tom Maciejewicz, we can laugh about it, you know, the instant media star one game. But the bottom line is he did a heck of a job getting this team ready to play. They lose their head coach and, you know, a lot of distractions, playing a better, a more talented Fresno State team. But they came out and they were able to run the football. They were more physical. They wanted to win more. And a lot of that goes to the coaching staff and the motivation they had for this game.
Absolutely. Not just the upheaval on the coaching staff, but the way they lost the conference championship game. They were expected to beat Miami of Ohio. They had them on the ropes. A 4th-and-20 conversion on a tipped pass led to NIU losing that conference championship game. So that they had to bounce back from that. That's an impressive statement. It's a long way from Boise back to DeKalb, but you can tell that the party beginning in the blue rug is going to carry back to Northern Illinois.
Enjoy.
Would you vote them in the poll now? 11 wins again, should have had a 12th win if they didn't lose the MAC championship game.
You know what, I ranked them at 25 before that MAC championship game. They lose and obviously you knock them out, but after watching how impressively they beat a good Fresno State team, not a great but a pretty good Fresno State team, depending on how things shake out, I wouldn't have a problem putting them at 24, 25, somewhere in there.
A Fresno team that did beat Illinois at the end of the season, but the Bulldogs kind of doing what they do. When they take on an AQ team in a bowl, they do well. When it's a non-AQ, even though Pat Hill talked up NIU, The Bulldogs didn't really show up, and they lost emphatically. Well, earlier in the Mexico Bowl, a couple of 6-6 teams, BYU and UTEP, so Mountain West versus WAC, rival conferences. And Jake Heaps, a quarterback that came up with a lot of hype to Provo, struggled at the beginning of the season, as you'd expect a freshman to do. But boy, did he play well down the stretch and in this game.
You can see just the confidence that he has gotten, sometimes getting away too, and looking just at your mistakes earlier in the season, having the time off before the bowl game. See here another touchdown pass, just throwing the ball with confidence, delivering it, knows where he wants to go with the football. Big difference from early in the season.
That's Cody Hoffman on the receiving end, two of his three touchdown catches. Hoffman, 8 for 137. Heaps threw for 264 and four touchdowns. And when you see freshman to freshman and you put half a hundred plus on the board, it makes you feel good about 2011, even though it was a disappointing overall season for BYU, 7-6. They were in some games, let the Utah game slip away. But you like what you see from the pitch and catch combo.
Yeah, I think you have to be excited about, as you said, both freshmen. They win six of their last seven games. This is a quarterback that has a lot of talent. You can see just in those highlights, being able to drive the ball down the field. He's improving almost every single game from a understanding the passing game standpoint. And I think that BYU has a great young tandem and a lot to build on going into next season.
One of the fun things about bowl season is keeping that conference scorecard. So a win for the MAC and a win for the Mountain West on the opening day of bowl season. And the Mountain West, of course, has had great success in bowl games in recent years. They won the Challenge Cup last year and again 3 years ago. Pac-10 was perfect in the 08-09 bowl season. One conference that has never won the Challenge Cup but has the best overall winning percentage in bowls over these years is the SEC. Typically, the SEC has tougher bowl matchups than the Mountain West, but you got to hand it to the Mountain West, and off to a great start.
It's going to be tough to keep these scorecards with all the realignment and the shift. Exactly. And the Mountain West has become the WAC next year.
Yeah, for now, TCU and BYU count right. The Mountain West. Hey, news in Maryland, Ralph Friedgen has been told by the university he cannot coach the team next season. That's according to sources there. Kevin Anderson is the AD. A guy who was brought in from West Point, did not hire Friedgen, has had some success, got the Terps to play well down the stretch. But, you know, when you're told you can't coach next season, and there have been rumors, perhaps, that Mike Leach is next in line, although Leach's agent says the school hasn't contacted him and there's nothing imminent. But, boy, we're seeing some strange, unusual coaching decisions, coaching moves being made.
Big business.
Yeah.
This reeks of big business when you think about it. Just so much money in college football right now, and you talk about all the conference realignment, all having to do with television rights and bottom line dollars. And I think we're seeing that you have to go on and find the coach that you want, and new people coming in as athletic directors and making big decisions. West Virginia, the decision that they've made, bringing in Dana Holgorsen from Oklahoma State. How about the small trend we had with the head coach in waiting? Well, that's gone because you can't hold on to your head coach anymore. We're going to come in and swoop them up, just like we saw Florida with Texas's Will Muschamp. So I think it all comes back to money and just having to succeed right now.
Yeah, and big business on the part of the schools. They made some pretty cold-blooded decisions, but coaches do the same thing.
Right.
Muschamp's a very interesting situation where he kind of leaves Mack Brown high and dry. He said for the one job that he would leave his coach-in-waiting status at Texas for Gainesville, which it's a great job, and you can't blame him, but it's just symptomatic of this. And, you know, Friedgen, two wins last year. He got up to 8 wins this year. He figured he's getting more solid ground.
That's a one-year extension.
Yeah. They're trying to force him out, trying to get him to resign, and he has not done that. All right, to the relative sanity of Division III football in the championship game today, the Stag Bowl in Virginia. Familiar matchup. You D3 fans know it's always Wisconsin-Whitewater against Mount Union. 6 straight years. This is Whitewater. Lavelle Coppedge busts in for the touchdown. He had a monster game. This opened the scoring. It would be back and forth. Mount Union would be within 3 points at halftime, trying to sit in that lead. And
nice
all of a
move.
Sudden, Coppedge, look at this guy. Is he any kind of a prospect?
Yeah, I got to get back home and start breaking down more tape, Chris.
299 and 3 touchdowns, and Whitewater knocks off the longtime power in Division III. They back up their championship. They've now won 3 of the last 4. Now, Mount Union still leads all time with 10 national titles, but these teams just go on forever and ever. Will they match up again next year?
And bet on it.
Only one other team. You know, 5 of the teams have the one title. Delaware and Georgia Southern is the semifinal game in Division I-AA. That's Pat Devlin. Now, Penn State fans will remember that he got beat out for the job, transferred to Delaware. He threw a couple of touchdown passes. Just walking through the Georgia Southern defense right there in the third quarter. That would break the game open a little bit. This would put it away.
Touchdown.
touchdown run of the Blue Hens marched through to the championship game. Devlin finishing with 137 yards.
CAA has become a power in FCS.
Delta State and Minnesota Duluth, the Division II national championship game, tight game in the fourth quarter. Brad Foss will take the handoff out of the shotgun with a 12-yard touchdown run, 17-14 Minnesota Duluth. Now tied at 17 in the final minute. Micah Davis trying to make something happen, but the ball overthrown, and Cody Ike there to pick it off. Takes it back 20 yards. And Duluth in business. David Nadeau from 32 yards, a chance to win it, win the championship with a walk-off field goal.
Don't think too much.
Not straight through, just curls it inside the left upright. He goes crazy. Off comes the helmet. Minnesota Duluth, national champions, 20-17. That is good stuff. What a concept. Settling the thing on the field with a bracket, with no poles and no computers involved.
Something to think about.
But I digress. Back to the bowl subdivision. And let's talk about your games before January 1, when the games really get tasty and the matchups get more big time. Your top three December games and reasons to watch them.
Well, first of all, I'd start with Iowa versus Missouri. And obviously, Iowa's struggling right now, losing some of their top players to suspensions. Darrell Johnson Koulianos is the wide receiver who's gone. They lose Adam Robinson, the running back, as well. But you have a great quarterback matchup in this game. Ricky Stanzi, quarterback for Iowa, has done a really good job this year. It hasn't shown up in the wins and losses compared to 2009, but he is an improved quarterback, much more efficient, much more consistent. Can he get it done without his two playmakers that I mentioned? Then the flip side, Blaine Gabbert, who I think is the second best pro prospect in all of college football besides Andrew Luck at the quarterback spot.
The South Carolina takes on Florida State. I guess we're going to have to see if Christian Ponder's healthy. That's big.
That's obviously a huge key. And Christian Ponder really was playing well when he came back from the injury. The big question I have on the other side of the ball, this number two ranked defense in terms of sacks for Florida State, going up against Steven Garcia, quarterback for South Carolina, has been up and down this year, had some big moments, but he tends to make mistakes under pressure. Can he avoid those big turnovers?
I'm looking forward to Oklahoma State and Arizona.
Can Arizona bounce back defensively? Giving up 36 points a game in the final four games, all losses. This is not the offense you want to face if you're struggling on the defensive side. Mike Stoops got to rally the troops against Brandon Weeden, the quarterback, and Justin Blackman, the number one receiver in all of college football in terms of receptions and reception yards.
Well, coming up next, Troy and Ohio U in New Orleans. That's Corey Robinson, the quarterback for the Trojans, to veteran coaches Larry Blakeney and Frank Solich colliding next up on ESPN. For a preview, let's go to Mark Neely and Robert Smith in the Superdome.
Chris, thanks very much, and welcome to the Big Easy for tonight's matchup between Ohio and Troy in the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. Mark Neely, along with Robert Smith, right outside the Superdome next to the vehicle that brings Robert to and from the hotel. Now, for Troy, this is a football team that has a very special player, Jarrell Jernigan, that can score in so many different ways.
Yeah, really one of the most explosive and versatile players in all of college football. He's the Sun Belt all-time leader in receptions, has run for a couple touchdowns this season, thrown for a touchdown, and returned a kick and a punt for a touchdown. Really a lot of fun to watch.
Very special player. Now for Ohio, the Bobcats, their head coach, Frank Solich. This is the third time in his six seasons that he has brought Ohio to a bowl game, but never in the school's history have they won a bowl. That's imperative for them tonight.
Yeah, it really is. Bit of a disappointment at the end of the season, not making it to the MAC title game because of their regular season loss in the finale to Kent State, but always fundamentally sound, especially on the defensive side of the ball.
To Ohio and Troy in the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. Now let's send it back to Chris in the studio.
All right, thank you. So MAC against Sunbelt. Troy scores 34 a game. They allow 32 a game. Gamecocks put 69 on them, the second most points allowed in the history of the program. But Jernigan, the only guy in college football tied who scored five ways. They talked about his talents, 5'9", 180, but speedy.
You talk about the NFL and what all scouts say, speed and versatility. And he has both. You see him in the wildcat package at times. He's going to get back there and become the trigger man. You'll see him in the return game, over 600 yards in the return game this season, almost 800 yards receiving, and over 300 yards rushing. This guy does it all. He's going to be fun to watch tonight. You have power, physical team for Ohio going up against that spread finesse team for Troy offensively. I think this will be the most interesting, the closest of the three bowl games today.
Okay, well, we haven't had two competitive games
yet. It's really not a big statement.
R&L Carriers, New Orleans Bowl, coming up next.
watching ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
One of America's most distinctive cities, New Orleans. The cuisine and culture make it a popular tourist destination and the home for the 10th annual R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. The Ohio Bobcats are searching for the school's first ever bowl win. Troy looks to avenge its two overtime losses in its last two bowl trips. Welcome to the Bayou and the 10th annual R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. We are at the historic Superdome, the Louisiana Superdome, for this matchup between the MAC and the Sun Belt. It is the Ohio University Bobcats and the Troy University Trojans. And happy holidays to you. Great to have you along, Mark Neely, along with former Vikings and Ohio State running back Robert Smith, also Quinn Kesnick here. We'll hear from him in just a bit. Now, Robert, both these teams have some similarities. They both were 6-2 in conference play in their respective conferences, and both needed some help to get here.
Yeah, they really did. Ohio lost their season finale to Kent State, so they lost their chance at the MAC championship game. And then Troy, during the season, they dropped a game to FIU and needed FIU to lose another game, and FIU ended up losing their season finale to Middle Tennessee State. So here they are.
So it sets up tonight's matchup. Ohio, again, looking for their first ever bowl win, and their defense really has been the veteran part of their team.
Yeah, it really has been a very solid core, really led by that defensive line. Normally, 4 fifth-year seniors on that defensive line. This game, they're only going to be 3 of them because Ernie Hodge is out with an injury. But watch for Stafford Gatling, number 36, 13.5 tackles for loss this season. A very solid group. They're the 14th-ranked rush defense in the country, and Frank Solich said coming into this ball game, that's what we at least have to do against this Troy team, have to try and stop the run because we know they're going to get the pass yards.
Yeah, the Ohio defense will be tested by that hurry-up offense of Troy, and they have number 3, Jarrell Jernigan, spectacular player who can score in so many ways.
Yeah, he really can. He's not just going to test their defense, he's going to test their special teams as well. And as you said, he can score in so many ways. He is now the all-time leading receiver in Sun Belt history, but he's run for a couple touchdowns this year. He's even thrown for a touchdown, and he's returned a kick and a punt return for a touchdown this year. He is an electrifying player, going to be fun to watch on Sundays as well next year.
You will want to keep an eye on number 3 for the Troy Trojans. This is the first ever meeting between Ohio and Troy, the 10th annual R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. The finale of 3 games to begin the bowl season on this Saturday. So you park it in a comfortable chair and relax with us here in the Big Easy.
Here's to the things that keep us comfortable. Good friends, loyal dogs, and a pair of great-fitting jeans. Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans. For long-lasting comfort, the right choice is Wrangler. Real, comfortable jeans.
Can we turn the AC up? I'm dying back here.
Jeff, eat a Snickers, please.
Why?
Every time you get hungry, you turn into a diva.
A diva?
Yes, a diva.
Okay.
Thank you. Better?
You're not you when you're hungry.
Better.
Snickers satisfies.
Well, it's been a great year, sir. We've saved people a lot of money on car insurance.
Feels nice going into the holidays. Oh. Will you marry me? Ooh, Helzberg Diamonds.
Yeah, well, he must have saved some money with Geico. Reminds me of the Gecko mating call.
Really? How does that go?
Shooby-doo, shooby-dooby-doo-doo.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Back here at the Superdome for the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl, Ohio and Troy tonight. And the third member of our broadcast team is Quint Kestick. He's on the sidelines with the Troy head coach, Larry Blakeney.
Coach, you've used all sorts of nicknames this year. You called the whole season the Drive for 5, and you captured your fifth straight Sun Belt title. You said your 7th win was heaven. 8 would be tonight. What would that mean?
That would be great. 8 would be great. We need to win a bowl game. We've
We've had some luck, but we've had two double overtime losses the last two times out in bowls. We need to put our best foot forward against a good team.
What is the biggest challenge that Ohio presents?
Well, they're a running football team, buddy, and you better stop the run or they'll keep you away from your possessions, your share of the possessions mostly. So we got to make sure that we get off the field from them.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Mark.
Good, thanks very much. Larry Blakeney, the head coach, will face off against Frank Solich tonight in his sixth year in Athens, Ohio. He was the 2006 MAC Coach of the Year. Of course, won the Big 12 Coach of the Year a couple of times in 99 and 01 when he was the head coach at his alma mater, the University of Nebraska. Ohio 8-4 overall. They went 6-2 in the East Division of the MAC. Troy 7-5 overall. They went 6-2 in conference play in the Sun Belt. They had lost a couple of games back-to-back to FIU and then to South Carolina, won their last two. So that got Troy to the seven wins. And for Ohio, this is an offense that really features two quarterbacks. One is Bo Jackson. The other is this man right here, Phil Bates.
Yeah, Phil Bates looks kind of like a linebacker when you see him. Got a nice big old hand, too, a strong guy, and he's more of the runner. You can see his numbers there. Not great with the passing, but that job is mostly left to Bo Jackson. The fantastic player, dual threat quarterback as well. You'll see him running out of the pistol formation. They like to use that a lot. Very dangerous players, both of them.
Well, Troy won the toss and they have deferred, so Ohio will get the ball first to begin the game. And Troy will be wearing their Cardinal red uniforms with the silver and black trim, the white pants, and Ohio in the white with the green trim. Michael Taylor, junior from Pensacola, Florida, kick it off. And we are underway from New Orleans. A short end over end that comes down at the 10 to Dante Harden. Gets to the 20, finds a crease, 25, 30, bangs ahead to the 34-yard line, and that's where the Bobcats will begin. A 24-yard kick return for Harden, brought down by Brandon Kitt. And Robert, who do we need to look for? Impact players when Ohio has the football.
Boy, Terrence McRae provides really tough matchup problems for this Troy defense. He's a very tall receiver. They're very short at the cornerback position. And Bo Jackson, we talked about him, put up some great numbers. He's a great dual threat quarterback. And Jonathan Massaquoi, you know, they talked about him. They say he looks like a skier when he's out there sometimes because of his body lean. He's so good at controlling his body. We'll be talking about him throughout the night.
So in the pistol, it's the quarterback Bates with Davidson, the back, and running right in the option. Bates is going to pitch it, and Davidson got stacked up right near the line of scrimmage. Maybe gets about a half yard. Jimmy Anderson, the quarterback, one of those to come up and make the initial contact.
Great job by the Troy defense there, really bottling that play up. You know, option football, it's so funny. So many people say, you know, one guy's got the quarterback, one guy's got the pitch man. They try and make it a lot more simple than it really is. I mean, in a normal running play, everybody's got the same responsibility, but Troy did a nice job stringing that play off.
Davidson still the back with Bates the quarterback. We have to keep a close eye for Bo Jackson, number 8, to see when he enters this football game for the Bobcats. Fakes the handoff, play action under pressure, throws deep, going for a man, and caught it, intercepted by Jimmy Anderson. He overthrew the intended receiver, McRae, and Troy with the pick.
As we said, Phil Bates, not really known as much for throwing in this. See right there, McRae trying a little double move. Anderson doesn't bite on that at all. Does a nice job looking this ball in. Kind of caught that one like a receiver. Nice job by Jimmy Anderson there.
Third interception of the season for Jimmy Anderson, a junior from Round Rock, Texas, near Austin at Round Rock High School. Now we get to see the NASCAR hurry-up offense of the Troy Trojans. Their quarterback, a redshirt freshman, Corey Robinson. Ron Harris in the backfield with him. Robinson immediately looks right, throws. It's caught by Brent Moncrief. He scoots ahead to the 35-yard line, and just like that, picks up 13 yards on Troy's first play. Eric Benjamin with the tackle.
Boy, Corey Robinson back in high school. We've been having so much fun with this one back in the studios. Kept asking people how many touchdowns they think he threw for his senior year in high school. 91 touchdowns against only 4 interceptions 2 years ago when he was in high school.
Absolutely incredible. Robinson now looking left. It's caught by Gill. flag is down. Immediately hit and dropped at the 38-yard line. We'll get the call. And Stafford Gatling.
Offsides, 76 on the defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
I think he means 36. Stafford Gatling was offside for the Bobcats.
Well, 13 and a half tackles for loss on the season. You know, he's a little bit excited playing in this environment, playing in the Superdome. Just got off a little bit early there. Corey Robinson knew he had a free play.
Sean Southward now the back. He gets the carry, running left, trying to turn the corner. Being pursued, turns that corner across the 45. They're going to say he's out at the 47-yard line. A gain of 6. Posey helped escort him out.
Well, nothing fancy really about Sean Southward on film, but I tell you, he just got great instincts. And you can see right there, knew exactly how far he needed to get outside before he could turn that one up. Did a nice job getting upfield.
Here's the pitch. Jernigan gets his first touch, turns the right corner, eludes a couple of tacklers, has a first down all the way inside Ohio territory near the 40-yard line. Eric Benjamin eventually brought it down. But watch him, Robert. Jernigan weaving through traffic.
He does such an excellent job negotiating traffic. You can see right here, he's such a natural runner. If he was a little bit bigger, he'd probably be a running back. Does a nice job there getting up, making people miss.
Juan Harris, the back, and he gets his first carry. Runs off left tackle, bumps off one tackler, gets inside the 35. Working down around the 33-yard line for a pickup of 8. And already we're mentioning Eric Benjamin, the weak side linebacker's name frequently. There he is, number 30.
Yeah, and Donovan Fletcher came down, had a shot there, just didn't wrap up to Juan Harris. Juan Harris is more physical back than Sean Southward. Really does an excellent job getting downhill. I'll tell you, you better bring it if you want to bring this guy down. You have to wrap him up.
Jonathan Chandler is now the quarterback, and he swings it out. They get it to Jernigan, and the turf makes the tackle that time on Jernigan. Well, Jarrell Jernigan, not to make excuses, he's been a little ill the last few days, but taking some fluids. That time just lost his footing.
Greg did. You can see the Ohio defense did an excellent job reading and recognizing the bubble screen there. Jernigan tries to come back inside, just loses his footing, which is easy to do on this kind of turf.
So he lost 5. That turns this into a much more difficult 3rd down and 7 for what was a 2nd and 2. Corey Robinson back in as the quarterback. Harris throwing back, and the catch made at the 30, and he did get the first down where they spot him out after the catch by Eric Thomas.
Corey Robinson does a nice job sitting in there. They pick up the blitz very well.
Nice grab.
Thomas, nice. Big. He's a big guy out there. He's got some nice soft hands.
6'3", 195 pounds as Thomas gets his first catch of his Arnold Carrier's New Orleans Bowl. Now swung out. Harris made a nice move to avoid Benjamin initially and gets down inside the 25 near the 23-yard line.
Well, Benjamin's that guy replacing Noah Keller, the linebacker from last year. 155 tackles they lost with Noah Keller being out. Eric Benjamin there just didn't do a very good job of breaking down his feet. Got to credit Juan Harris, though. He's a physical runner, but he's got some nice feet.
2nd down and 6. And a handoff. Harris cuts it left. Jump steps up near the 20-yard line. Still going to be a yard and a half or so shy of the first down. Marcellus Williamson, the nose guard, the one to make the tackle there. There's the redshirt senior from East Cleveland, Ohio.
Yeah, and Williamson's one of those space eaters, and as you can see, he eats more than space. He's a big guy, 325 pounds, but you get a guy like that in the middle of the defensive line, just so hard to get any sort of movement on him, can disrupt a lot of types of plays.
On 3rd and short, able to keep his feet, Harris has a first down and more inside the 15, picks up 8. Eric Benjamin, again, the one to trip him up.
And Dak Nottenstein had a shot at him in the backfield there, and Benjamin does a nice job getting Juan Harris down finally.
So they go to the Wildcat with Jernigan to trigger the Wildcat. In motion comes Mitchell, fakes the handoff to him. Jernigan going to cut it left, turn the corner, and get into the end zone for a Troy touchdown. His third rushing touchdown of the season. He has 5 TD receptions, and it doesn't take long for us to see the impact of number 3, Jarrell Jernigan.
Boy, he's such a dangerous player, and these jet sweep type plays really put a lot of pressure horizontally on defenses. See on the backside. There's no way to catch him if you stop your feet. Donovan Fletcher had a shot at him there on the backside, but Jarrell Jernigan is just such a dangerous player once he gets people to stop their feet.
Off the uprights, and Taylor sneaks it through. Taylor's missed a handful of point afters this season. Nearly missed one there. Jernigan scoring early for Troy.
Introducing the bigger four-door all-wheel drive Mini Countryman.
How about the taste of a barbie on the beach this holiday? Come on into Outback and try our special sirloin served with our freshly grilled lobster tails. It's here for a limited time at just $14.95. And purchase $100 in gift cards, get a $20 bonus card free. It's always fresh in the Outback. I say, hey, I'll be gone again.
Tradition, the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. Holiday gift collection at Macy's.
For frequent heartburn relief, nothing beats Prevacid 24-Hour. Just one pill helps keep you heartburn-free for a full 24 hours. Prevent the acid that causes frequent heartburn with Prevacid 24-Hour. All day, all night, nothing works better.
Welcome on board, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to thank you for traveling with us. For your convenience, you can find 4 exits, 2 at the front and 2 at the back. Enjoy your drive and have a nice day.
Introducing the bigger 4-door Mini Countryman.
Good evening. My name is Bob Zimmerman, president of R&L Carriers. On behalf of our valued employees and customers worldwide, it's an honor to deliver tonight's game, the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. We would like to welcome the Sun Belt Conference co-champion, Troy Trojans, and the MAC representative, Ohio University Bobcats. These student-athletes demonstrate the same passion and dedication to succeed as found throughout the R&L Carriers organization. We hope you enjoy tonight's game and wish you a safe and happy holiday season.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
It did not take the Trojans long, scoring on their first possession after the interception by Jimmy Anderson. Jarrell Jernigan with a 12-yard touchdown run. 10-play drive, ate up nearly 80 yards in just over 4 minutes. So already the Bobcats, one of their 2 quarterbacks, Bates, and I'm sure we'll see Boo Jackson at some point. And they find themselves down an early touchdown. Mark Neely with Robert Smith. Quinn Kesnick from the Superdome in New Orleans. Harden takes it from the 7. Smashed out before he could get to the 20. Stopped shy of the 20-yard line. Donnie Thompson helping out on special teams.
Go back and look at this play. You can see Donnie Crosby, number 87, tight end for Troy, matched up against Stafford Gatling. And take a look at Donovan Fletcher, number 29 there. Just gets his nose too far to the inside. Has to contain on that backside. Understand that Jernigan can come out of that back end.
Bates does come back out as the quarterback for the Bobcats. Yet to see Boo Jackson in this game. Vince Davidson in the back. They'll send it tight end in motion, Jordan Thompson. And again, running left, Davidson for a couple of yards. The tackle by the weak side linebacker, Brandon Bryant.
They're still looking for Boo Jackson to get in this ball game. Had an academic issue that came up this week.
Yeah, he failed to attend a required internship, so he was a few hours short. So So there was some concern, at least for a few days, that he may not be eligible to play, but he finished out the internship with the required hours. Did not travel with the team here initially, but joined them a little bit later. And, of course, eligible to play tonight is Bo Jackson. In motion, Goulet, he takes the handoff on the fly sweep. Running right, gets a nice block, but up to the 26-yard line before Jonathan Massaqua, that defensive end, ran all the way with that big wide receiver to the corner and brought him down.
Oh, Jonathan Massaqua did an excellent job on this play. Runs all the way from the backside here. See what kind of motor he has. And some good genes in that family. Got Tim Massaqua, a former tight end in the NFL. Muhammad Massaqua, wide receiver. And Cassante Shankle, all three of those guys are cousins of Jonathan Massaqua.
So third and short, third and one. The Bobcats just 5 of 26 on third down, though, in their last couple of games. Bates to keep it. Pushes across the 30, and he'll have the first down with a pickup of 3. And Brandon Bryan with the tackle.
Well, this is what makes Phil Bates so dangerous as a runner, just such a physical presence back there. Does a nice job on the fake and then keeps the ball himself. And, well, you better come in a little lower if you want to tackle Phil Bates.
So first down for the Bobcats from their own 31-yard line. Davidson the back. In motion to tight end Thompson. And he'll keep it. Bates pulled it right out of the belly of Davidson. Runs with it himself all the way up to the 41-yard line for a gain of 11.
A little bit surprised. Troy is still keeping their safeties pretty high. And Phil Bates, we talked before, he's not really the thrower of the quarterback duo. As long as they're running like this, I would keep my safeties down in the box, trying to get extra people in there to tackle a big guy like Phil Bates.
Well, Bates waved to the sideline and came off, so Bo Jackson has come in as the quarterback now. So first play of the game for Jackson. Jackson's going to keep it. Nope, gave it away. Fooled everybody. Davidson in the Troy territory, inside the 35, a pickup of 24 yards before the strong safety Ladarius Mann finally ran him down. Nice fake here at the beginning of this play.
Yeah, it really was, and Vince Davidson does a nice job stepping through traffic here initially. See, finds the hole late. Once he gets there, it gets vertical quickly. Does a nice job getting upfield.
So Jackson hands off one time. And Bates comes right back into the game. First and 10 Bobcats in the 34-yard line of Troy. Takes the handoff to Davidson. Makes the pitch around the left side. Terrence McCray, and that one read well by the Troy defense. No gain. It was Daniel Sheffield, the strong side linebacker, with the tackle.
Start to see a little rotation now in that defensive secondary for Troy. They are starting to play this run a lot heavier, but a nice job staying disciplined on the backside of this play, not falling for that action front side.
So under 6 minutes to go in this first quarter. Bo Jackson back now as the quarterback for the Bobcats. Goulet comes in motion. Get it to him. Immediately brought down right at the 37-yard line. No gain. Xavier Lamb, the middle linebacker, the free safety, Willard Ross with the stop.
This Ohio offense is going to have to start throwing the ball back in these Troy defenders out of the box. You just load up the box. You know that it's more than likely going to be a run. Have to make a defense respect your ability to pass the football, or they are going to make adjustments like that.
Seven plays on this drive. All of them have been on the ground. But now, on third and long, to pass. Jackson towards the end zone. Touchdown! Stephen Goulet had to wait just a fraction of a second for that pass to get to him. Steps into the end zone, and Ohio answers with the touchdown pass for Jackson, his 16th of the season.
Well, the receivers coach Dwayne Dixon
says about Goulet. He can take a small play and turn it into a big play. Does a nice job getting behind the defense here. And Darius Madden just wasn't able to get over in time, number 30. Nice play by Goulet and a nice throw.
First touchdown catch of the year for Goulet. Matt Weller's point after knocked through, and it ties us up. Well, Boo Jackson seeing some action on the Bobcats' second series. He comes right back and ties up this R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl.
Over 40 years ago, we made our first delivery. Today, R&L Carriers is one of the largest privately owned transportation companies in the U.S. With a state-of-the-art transportation network, R&L Carriers provides solutions for LTL, truckload, domestic, and international freight. We ship anything, anywhere, anytime. For world-class online customer service, visit GoRLC.com. R&L Carriers, your global transportation provider.
Introducing the bigger four-door all-wheel drive Mini Countryman.
With the Capital One Venture Card, we get double miles on every purchase. So we earned a holiday trip to the Big Apple twice as fast.
Dinner!
We get double miles every time we use our card. And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang. It's hard to beat double miles.
I want a mace, a sword,
Get the Venture Card from Capital One and earn double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
I wonder what it can be.
What's in your wallet?
This is the iPhone 4. Its lithium polymer battery lets you work longer, play longer, laugh longer, listen longer, shoot, edit, share, update, download, read, write, and even FaceTime longer. All on the world's thinnest smartphone, the iPhone 4.
Introducing the bigger four.